up, everybody? It's Black Indian Chief. We back in the booth. I'm gonna check my audios real fast. I don't expect many people to come. I'm just finna
Okay, the audio sound real good. I can hear a lot of my background now. Okay.
So this video, man, this video is going to be about so much. I hate typing, you all. And so, you know what I'm saying? It's going to be hard for me to be putting descriptions in whenever I do a stream from the computer. But don't worry about it. You know what I'm saying? We're back in the booth. Now, this stream is going to be by online and tell you what all we're going to go over today. We're going to go over the history of NASA. We're gonna NASA meaning in Hebrew. We're gonna go to ancient space travel, timeline of the Antarctica exploration, timeline of Freemasonry, timeline of empires, timeline of Christianity, the timeline of authors of the Bible, John Jacob Astor, journey and other one. We're gonna read some parts out of that book, Adolf Hitler, timeline. Line of the Illuminati in the North Pole, Mayan timeline, ancient civilization timeline, animals indigenous to Asia, indigenous to the Americas, animals indigenous to Africa, Europe, etc. and so forth. We're going to go over the plants and different species, and we're going to go over the different human species, and we're going to take a brief look into eugenics and see how eugenics left out a whole lot. In that the eugenics guy, beyond popular belief, may have been saying some correct information, but man, we're going to get into all that. We're going to go into the giants. We're going to go into the timeline of flight and space travel. We're going to go into Leonardo da Vinci's inventions. We're going to go into a brief history of Madame Vlatsky, time traveler articles, plants indigenous to North America, plants indigenous to South America, etc. so forth. Brief history of Dr. Sabi, etc. so forth. We're going to go into Elohim beings, the Elohim, the pre-Adamites. We're going to go into infinite plane, plants and animals indigenous to the Amazons, the pygmies map they drew. We're going to go into different ancient maps, etc., etc. But anyway, let me get back right here and share the screen. Let me check the audio real fast. Yeah, if I'm too loud, if I sound too loud, you all just cut down your volume a little bit, because I got a little music playing, and if you just missed on all the topics, we're finna go back. Just rewind the video like 60 seconds and listen to all the topics. I just ran over like 40, 50 different topics we're finna show, and I'm finna screen share right now. Make sure you hit the like. Empress Ty Brown, peace, love, wisdom, and balance. Indeed. I got the masculine energy. You just bring the feminine energy into the chat. It doesn't matter how long stay. We do got divine wisdom and balance, and much love. But I'll go back over. We're finna go into so much. I'm finna go in basically, in this stream, we're gonna debunk this whole westernized scientific type, white supremacy type doctrine and indoctrination and educational systems and all of that. Plus, we're gonna show improve the so-called Western Hemisphere and the Eastern Hemisphere are two different planets. You know what I'm saying? And there's no such thing as planets. You know what I'm saying? The planets are really flat planes or like spheres. You know what I'm saying? Spear-like things, and they're set everywhere. And we think that, you know what I'm saying? When water is rising, they're giving passage. I'm going to get into all of that. Anyway, so I'll start. I want to start with, and let me know if I'm too loud. Let me know if my vocal's good, sis. Let me know if I'm too good, too loud. Okay, I'm finna start screen share. Peace, peace, higher powers, peace. Let me know if the audio. We're gonna start off in this build. We finna uncover all kind of hidden truths. So look, we're gonna start off right here with NASA. Okay, we get the NASA space program. We're finna show you that NASA is full of, you know what I'm saying? But we're not gonna stick on this. Remember, we're finna talk about all types of things, and I'm gonna show and prove the little stuff I had in the title isn't anything, you know what I'm saying, compared to what we're about to do, you all. Let me say, for y'all that's unfamiliar with me, you know what I'm saying, it's Black Indian Chief, you know what I'm saying? This is a new channel, you know what I'm saying? It's a branch channel from The Hive, which is Indigenous Realist main channel. Today, we're finna build on NASA. We're gonna show and prove how NASA has, which will be full of crap. We're gonna show you where that, we're gonna concepts of space travel and outer space come from. We're gonna show you where the person that made those concepts and that made those theories of gravity and space travel and all that, that they got it from someone who wrote it in a book, in a fictional book. You know what I'm saying? And we're going to look at everything. And then we're going to go and show you how Europeans, according to science, you know what I'm saying, and according to conscious thought, you know what I'm saying, is Africans and all the rest of these foreign people are actually aliens, and that's why they call them aliens. You know what I'm saying? That's why they actually call aliens, you all. But we finna go. Let's go ahead and take off. Now, NASA space program, May 5th, 1961. America's first space flight. Astronaut Alan B. Shepard Jr. becomes the first American in space. Okay, astronaut Alan B. Shepard becomes the first American in space. Let's see what the space is he went to. And by the way, all of these, if y'all can see, all of these things listed, you know what I'm saying? And I'm going to be premiering this video on my main channel, by the way. But all of these topics you see floating across the top of your screen right now that I'm scrolling by, I just typed them in. I didn't do any research, so you're gonna see straight Google results. But look at each topic, it's a spark, you know what I'm saying, because they were just download sparks that was coming to my mind, and so I had some stuff, you know what I'm saying, which was because that's what we needed to, you know what I'm saying. All of these are tools, like I didn't take anything from it or add anything to it, and that's where the building comes in at. Where anyway, okay. He goes into space. Astronaut Alan B. Shepard Jr. becomes the first American in space. And that's in February 20th. Oh, okay. That's in May 5th, 1961. Pardon me. Now, February 20th, 1962. Circling the Earth. Despite a loose heat shield and an autopilot failure that forces him to manually pilot the craft, John Glenn becomes the first American to circle the Earth. Okay, so despite a loose heat shield, this is just circling the Earth. They say you need a loose heat shield. I mean, you need a heat shield. Let's see. Okay, audio and stuff's looking good, sounding good. Let's go. Now, let me go ahead and click on this. And I'm gonna be breaking down. I'm gonna be breaking stuff down the whole time. Let me.
It's not too dark in here.
It don't matter. The computer got enough light. Okay, let's get them. Okay, right here. What the fuck? They trying to hit me with a billion ads, y'all, because they know we streaming. My bad, y'all. They so slick with these ads, man. I guess we can't go to that site. It's not free. So let's go right here. Fuck it, fuck it. We finna go right here. Hey, when I do this, man, when I gather something earlier in the day, and then I try to come back and build on it. So maybe if I just start off, get myself into reading this PDF. Now, my claim, right? I made this claim in 2018. No one ever challenged me on it, so I'm gonna make it here again in 2020. Hit the like button for those that's in the stream. Hit the like button. I made this claim in 2018 that this is the this person right here, John Jacob Astor. His name is really John Jacob Astor the fourth. Yeah, John Jacob Astor the fourth, but it just says John Jacob Astor right here. He wrote this book called A Journey in Other Worlds, A Romance of the Future. In this book, this is where your outer space theory comes from. You know what I'm saying? Look at, you even get it. Look at, let me go to the top. Pardon me. I'm trying to work the touch screen. Okay, let's go. Let's go. We're just going to read the introduction. Okay. He says the protracted struggle between science and the classic appears to be drawing to a close, with victory about to perch on the banner of science, as a perusal of almost any university or college catalog shows. While a limited knowledge of both Greek and Latin is important for the correct use of our own language, the amount till recently required, in my judgment, has been absurdly out of proportion to the intrinsic value of these branches, or perhaps more correctly, roots of study. The classics have been thoroughly and painfully threshed out, and it seems impossible that anything new can be unearthed. We may equal the performances of the past, but there is no opportunity to surpass them or produce anything original. Even the much vaunted mental training argument is beginning to pale. For would not anything equally difficult give as good developing results? While by learning alive matter, we kill two birds with one stone. There can be no question that there are many forces and influence in nature whose existence we as yet little more than suspect. How much more interesting it would be if, instead of reiterating our past achievements, the magazines and literature of the period should devote their consideration to what we do not know. It is only through investigation and research that inventions come. We may not find what we are in search of, but may discover something of perhaps greater moment. It is probable that the principal glories of the future will be found in as yet but little trodden paths, And as Professor Cortland justly says at the close of his history, next to religion, we have most to hope from science. Preface. Okay. Okay, now we finna get into this now. Let me give you a backdrop on it. This is crazy. Watch this. Good information. So let me come up here. Let me let y'all see the brother. Hey, what up, everybody? It's Black Indian Chief. I'm gonna be premiering this same video that I'm streaming live right now over on the main Hive, you know what I'm saying, Indigenous Realist Channel. And when you all see this from the future at Indigenous Realist Channel, make sure you all subscribe to the link that's going to be inside the description to this video. And the importance of this book right here, right? John Jacob Astor was the Donald Trump of that day. Oh, I forgot to pull up the last president PDF. You know what I'm saying? That smoke in the adventures of Baron Trump. So if I remember that, I'll come back to that later. But those books are from the same time period, you know what I'm saying? And from that time period, that's some very classical literature. And that literature, you find a lot of Freemasonic writings where they reveal a lot of the truth, you know what I'm saying? Because think about it. If you're uncovering, think about it. Right now, today, we're going to uncover truths. I've uncovered a lot of truths throughout my life, you know what I'm saying? We all have. And when we do, we can't keep it to ourselves. That's the whole point of me expressing it now. So it'll go to the future. You get what I'm saying? So someone in the future can look me right in the eyes when I'm no longer around, when my bones and body and my flesh are turned into dust. Someone can look at this video and glean knowledge, wisdom, and understanding from experiences, just like all the ancient texts and all the ancient manuscripts and things of that nature that we have. Now, but look, check this out. This dude was a Donald Trump type character. Now, wait, before y'all bring out y'all Negro, you know what I'm saying, nooses and y'all Negro scalping, y'all Indian scalping things. Listen, ain't nobody getting my scalp. Before y'all bring it out, just know Donald Trump is all right with me. You know what I'm saying? It's Trump 2020. You know what I'm saying? He's not doing anything to this country that hasn't already been done. Matter of fact, he's not hurting it. You know what I'm saying? In so many ways, he's really helping it. You know what I'm saying? Now, but forget him, we're not on that. I just want to say, when I say he's a Donald Trump type character, he's a rich kid. No, he was someone who sprung forth out of prestigious European type family, an east world. I'm gonna call the eastern hemisphere the east world, and that's what this video is also about. You know what I'm saying? In this western hemisphere, the Americas, this is a whole world. The Americas, this is our world. Our world has been conquered. Do y'all get what I'm saying? Our country didn't get conquered. Our world got conquered. And I'm going to show and prove how worlds have been getting conquered over and over again. And I know this shit already sparked the term the new world into you all's mind. Now, let me get comfortable. Okay. No, I know I didn't just do that. Oh, okay. I thought I knocked something over. Now, anybody that's in the stream, make sure you like it. Make sure you subscribe to this channel. This is the only place you're going to get live smoke from. You know what I'm saying? This is my live smoke channel. Besides that, I'm not streaming on the main channel. The main channel is just Hive content. Anyway, let's dive in. Okay, the importance of this book, right? He springs forth from his family. We're going to go into the history of John Jacob Astor right after we read this book, read a little key terms out of this book. And the guy, and I'm smiling, you all, because I really like history. You know what I'm saying? I really consider myself a historian, a world historian, not just for the Americas, but I studied every part of these different worlds. And that's how I'm able to realize that these aren't different countries and different land masses and different continents. These are different worlds. And that's my hopes to show and prove throughout this series. You know what I'm saying? But we're going to make a big punch into modern science, into modern thought, schools of thoughts and everything. We're trying to make an impact. You know what I'm saying? This is an Aboriginal indigenous man coming with intellectual smoke. coming with spiritual smoke, coming with cosmic smoke. You know what I'm saying? I'm not claiming that it's me doing it. I'm claiming that I'm riding for the Most High. You know what I'm saying? And who has no name, who has no equals, who has no mother, son, daughters, husbands, wives, who has no genders, none of that. I'm saying the Creator, the Most High, and He sends me downloads, period. And He sends everybody the downloads. But the importance of this, let's go to it. Guy is really, oh, let me get the screen share. Sorry. I may slip up every once in a while, y'all. And remember, I'm going to be premiering it on the main channel, Indigenous Realists, after this is over. So we're closing this video. Smoke over there for the future. You know what I'm saying? I'm a master of time, you all. Like, we're gonna do this video with everybody. You know what I'm saying? On the main, I'm tired of missing all the content. You know what I'm saying? I want to see the content. I want to see the impact. If that makes any sense. Let's go. Where are we at? John Jacob Astor. Okay, look. My dude John Jacob Astor got hellified money. He's from a year. Let's go into the history first, if y'all don't mind. If you get bored, leave out. You can always catch it when we stream it from the main channel, y'all. This isn't for views or anything over here. This is just, we're finna go ahead and do the history first, man. I just wouldn't feel right, man. If we ain't dropped this history right now, man, I just wouldn't even feel right. Let's see. Oh, yeah, and everybody I'm going to be watching this from, everybody that's going to be watching, I'm talking from the future right now. Everybody that's going to be on the Indigenous Realist channel, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to be right there inside the mix with you all, you know what I'm saying? So be in the chat and comment, you know what I'm saying? Comment, comment, comment. This is the chief. This is the noble. This is the Buddha consciousness manifested here in the Americas. Forget what they got on the other side. How are we going to let people boost up conscious thought from everywhere else, and we not boosting up conscious thought? Y'all see, I'm a conscious person. Look at all my content. It's all conscious. You know what I'm saying? I didn't get taught by anybody. You can't find one stolen piece of information that I've ever put out. You can't find one concept that I've stolen and I gave credit. You know what I'm saying? I've never stolen a concept. All concepts are original, purely original, pure conscious thought manifested. Hiya. Hiya, 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 power. Back in the booth, the realist, the noble, the chief. Now, we finna get to this. Oh, man. Look, I ain't did this build in a minute. I dropped this build, like I said, I dropped this build in 2018. I dropped build in 2018, and I forgot the importance. Look. The reason why I compared him to Donald Trump, right? He was called the richest man in the world. No one knows about this man. This isn't part of a story. This isn't part of a book. John Jacob Astor, the richest man in the world. So let's look at the biography real fast and let's see how the hell this man was deemed the richest man in the world. And then I'm going to show you that this travel, this interplanetary travel that he's doing is actual interplanetary travel, and that these planets are right here located on the same plane that we all live on. You know what I'm saying? The same dimension. You know what I'm saying? The same frequency. We're all under this. See, the hemisphere, I'll give y'all a spoiler alert. The hemispheres, each form over a particular planet. You know what I'm saying? The strangeness of our planet, the reason why you get the infinity sign goes like this, you know, because that's showing the dual Earth. You know what I'm saying? You see the Western Hemisphere and the Eastern Hemisphere. That's the reason for the infinity sign. That's dual Earth. You know what I'm saying? You're seeing both sides, both hemispheres. You know what I'm saying? Two separate Earths and all stuff. You know what I'm saying? So these are little everybody. Think like Trump. He kind of look like Trump. He kind of wears hat like and everything. son Jacob was the wealthiest man in America in the early 19th century. And when he died in 1848, his fortune was estimated at least $20 million, and an astounding sum for the time. Wow, 1848, having $20 million, that's the equivalence to, oh shit, that's equivalence to the debt that Asia owes. That America owes China. Damn, about in my mind, you know, I just do it. Living, breathing, walking, talking mathematics. Hey, if I had $20 million back then, I know I would have made it to some trillions. Now, back then, do you know how much $20 million was? Early life. John Jacob Astor was born on July 17th, 1763, in the village of Wall, Germany. Wow. And that's something, during all my smoke, during all the bills I'm going to be doing, every piece of smoke I drop, you know what I'm saying, I'm going to be building on showing the German world, you know what I'm saying, that German world and their influences on the other worlds, the other so-called planets, the other so-called planes. And I'm going to show you the Asian world and the Asian influence on the so-called planes, and also this Indian, like, these are all different worlds, you know what I'm saying? Just different worlds. This is crazy. Don't sound crazy, but people will get it later. You know what I'm saying? When they tell you that you can go to Mars, you'll get it. You know what I'm saying? When they tell you, everybody, let's load up in this spaceship and let's go, you'll get it then. Okay, look, watch this. But I'm going to show you this Germany. Astor had... Have you ever heard of John Jacob Jingleheimer Smith? His name was my name too. Y'all heard that song? I'm gonna build on all that. Look, Astor had arrived in America as a poor German immigrant, and his determination and business sense led him to eventually create a monopoly in the fur trade. He diversified into real estate in New York City, and his fortune increased as the city grew. Early life. John Jacob Astor was born on July 17th, 1763, in the village of Waldorf in Germany. His father was a butcher, and as a boy, John Jacob would accompany him to jobs butchering cattle. While a teenager, Astor earned enough money at various jobs in Germany to enable him to relocate to London, where an older brother was living. He spent 3 years in England learning the language and picking up any information he could about his ultimate destination, the North American colonies, which were rebelling against Britain. Now, let's think about this, Trot. Think about this, higher powers. This is saying he's a teenager, right? So let's say he's about 15 years old. While a teenager, Astor earned enough money at various jobs in Germany to enable him to relocate to London. So he moves to London, where an older brother was living. So he moves to London, right? Then he spent 3 years in England learning the language and picking up any information he could about his ultimate destination. So he basically worked as almost like a spy, whether he was doing it for himself or someone else. But he says he spent, and it reminds me of this movie I just was watching about someone who kept on asking about the Indians. They kept on saying, what about those? Oh, I was watching The Last Samurai. And on The Last Samurai, the guy kept on asking them, so you said you fought these Indians. You fought the Indians over there in Americas. How do they fight? Is it true? You know what I'm saying? Asking him about how the strategy and stuff we were using. And he was like, it's true. They some bad mamma jammas. And so, but he kept asking that. He kept on asking it, like, so you survived against the Indians. And anyway, it just seems like this. He spent 3 years in England learning the language and picking up any information he could about his ultimate destination. What is his ultimate destination? The North American colonies, which were rebelling against Britain. Now, what people don't know, I'm going to go ahead, you know what I'm saying, for the people that's going to view this afterwards. I don't know who's in here. There's one person in here, so rock with me. But I'm, no way, I'm not screen sharing, man. Why ain't nobody said nothing? Come on. Come on. I haven't even been screen sharing, man. I appreciate nobody for being in here and didn't tell me I wasn't screen sharing. But we're going to build past. Look. Oh, we on the history. Wait. Okay. Look, cool. Y'all didn't need to read along anyway. It wasn't much because that's how real I am. Look, John Jacob Astor. Look at this 3. Let's look at this. 4, 5, 5. That's 14, which is a 5. That's power. You know what I'm saying? And that's 3. You know what I'm saying? So, but you know, look, how did he come up? Let's see. Fur trade. He became a millionaire when he made his first fortune in the fur trade. This guy. This rotund fella here is supposed to be a master fur trader. So he had heavy dealings. Hey, he had heavy dealings with copper color individuals. How? Because how in the heck else could you be a fur trader making $20 million back in 1843? And exactly what were you catching? Is that why there's no longer jaguars here? Is that why there's no longer? Because we're going to get into that. I'm gonna build on the indigenous. Matter of fact, I can go straight into it. Guy is a fur trader in Central here. I'm gonna let this shit go. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna stretch and let it go with the flow. So I'm gonna actually build pace, you all. So let me see. I'm looking for indigenous to the Americas. Okay, we got it right here. Okay, the native animals to the... See, this is saying to the United States. This is trickery. We didn't ask about the United States. We said indigenous to the Americas. Don't worry about it. The native animals to the United States are deer, moose, elk, and caribou, beavers, muskrats, squirrels, prairie dogs, porcupines, or marmots, weasels, fisher cat, skunk, badger, wolverine are also native to this country. We don't want the United States. Look, so we're going to go indigenous to North America. South America. Let's look at the... We're going to look at South America. We're going to look at Australia. No, we're going to look at just North America right now. Sorry, pardon me, y'all. We're just going to look at North America first, and then we'll do South America stuff when it comes up in the build. But right now, we're going to look at North America. Animals indigenous to the North America. To North America. Oh, animals native to North America. Okay, while there are many animals native to North America, the common ones are certain types of rats, squirrels, crows, eagles, pigeons, certain other common birds, raccoons, possums, black bears, alligators, many types of spiders and insects. Quite a few species of fish, crustacean like rainbow trout, suckers, lobsters, crawfish, etc., slugs. No, we want to see all of them. Because they missing so much. They are missing so freaking much. Let me K Mims, peace. Oh yeah. You tap in and we finna end all this white supremacy shit. And I mean that in the humblest way. And even white people should enjoy this. Even white people should benefit from me getting white supremacy from the land. Or as a people, as a civilization, be part of what's going on. There's more going on than just in what's going on in our neighborhood, these distractions and things of that nature. But I'm trying to come in the stream so I can give you a wrench. Okay, Mims. I'm finding the stream right now. Oh no, that's not it. That's not it. My bad. I'm gonna jump straight back in a bit. Also, peace, Lucius Gaines from the future. We're gonna watch the premiere from the future. Peace from the end. Peace to both of you all, to Ty Brown and to self, you all. I'm gonna wish myself peace from the future, nigga. Keep going. Now, I'm finna start back sharing the screen. We finna dive straight back in. We talking about so much. We're doing out of space, all this shit. And it's basically all the screen up. Because it all masonry and white supremacy. That's why this channel is called Black Indian Chief, because this is against white supremacy. You know what I'm saying? Indigenous realists can only go so far when it comes to white and black, because he doesn't play. Indian Chief has manifested because I'm tired of white supremacy. Well, the real. And I also have made astounding discoveries, you know what I'm saying, through diligent research, you know what I'm saying? And I made a sound discovery of different worlds and showing and proving that this is a new world, that America is a new world. You know what I'm saying? And it's all world theory. And now it's actually a true. And so let me go back in. I'm going straight back in. Okay. Talking master right now. So look, we got deer, beaver. Let's see. I mean, my shit. I think even. Still around like that, and they, and this shit was like Jurassic Park world. Jurassic Park. Oh, this nigga saying we live in nigga, bro. I'm saying there is another world, just like Jurassic Park, and that people, more privileged people in higher classes, people part of that 1%, are able to see me. I'm part of the five, you know what I'm saying? I'm just part of the poor righteous teachers, you know what I'm saying? I'm at the bottom of the barrel, you know what I'm saying? I'm not a worker bee, I'm not a worker ant, I'm not a drone, I'm not a bot, I'm not in the matrix, I'm just Neo out here. You didn't ever see Neo slide a debit card. You didn't ever see Neo goddamn me hesitate or wait on motherfucking me, anybody else in the movie, you know what I'm saying? Neo just glided through that shit in and out of the matrix, and that's what we're doing. So anyway, he was big game. That was the point I was bringing. When they're talking about first, I'm saying he was hunting big game. So he knocked up. This is why it's important. People would be like, why is it important though, Black Indian Chief? Because this is our country, and if I have to stated as this is the black man's country, I'll state it just as that, because it's like Professor Larry said on a video I just seen. I'm gonna be doing a build on that, getting on side numbers, but because he know better, you know what I'm saying? Professor Larry put it right in his face that all blacks aren't the same, and that woke me up, sparked me to make me realize, like, hey, we can't leave the blacks behind, because it leaves our brothers and sisters who still consider themselves black to fall into that self-hate. You know what I'm saying? The whole reason for this Aboriginal culture, this Aboriginal, this our culture and our people being studious and people information. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Oh yeah. Yeah. Appreciate it. Ooh, I got distracted. I came back where I could see you all. But yeah, we can't leave the blacks behind. How many millions of people consider themselves black and someone had action for them? You know what I'm saying? That's like we didn't got the information that we're Indian, that we're not from Africa, and now we're just gonna act like some superiorists. We're gonna act like Africans are inferior to us. We're gonna act like everybody. No, forget that. We're going to point out the inferior. We're going to separate the inferior to the superior. And we're going to see that though all skin, some people have origins. And we're going to see the worlds, the different worlds and different so-called plants people come from. You know what I'm saying? People don't think of planets. People don't think of planets when we talk about continents, when we talk about states. People don't think about, but we're going to get that plain truth out today. We're going to get that. Hey, watch this. Oh, we're going to get that plain truth out today, you all. In this peace, much love. Hi, y'all. Indigenous realist, the no chief, black Indian chief, the Buddha. Let me let some of this energy out. Since they came in, I'm going to let some of this energy out. Let me see. I'm screen sharing what I'm trying to do. What we covered so far. John Jay. So let's get back on point. As the richest man in the world. America's first, his first fortune in the fur trade. Okay, cool. I'm glad I just came back to this because we're going to keep it all the way 100. Me being an American. You know what I'm saying? I am an American. You know? No fool American to my bone grist. Right? You don't get more American than me, right? Me being American. And then representing self and family and culture and the genealogy and the ancestors, right? Let me do something. I know we've been in, let me see. Okay. Me being American, right? I gotta keep it 100. When they say John Jacob Astor is America's first millionaire, no. I say each individual so-called black, African American, American Indian, etc. In exclusion to anybody that immigrated or migrated to our world being the Western Hemisphere, before that migration of our world, that immigration to our world, you know what I'm saying? I say that we all are the first millionaires, billionaires, trillionaires, quadrillion, quadruple, zillion, gazillionaires. You get what I'm saying? Any bit of commerce, any bit of trade, any bit of money that has been made here in the Americas belongs to the Americas, to the original people of the Americas. We didn't give these people, we didn't give these people permission to come over here and settle our land. We didn't give them permission to do commerce. And these Moors are coming with this tricky information trying to get people to honor peace and freedom. The invader into history. We're not doing that, you all. We're not gonna write the invader. We're not gonna hate that. We're not gonna hate them. We're not gonna love them, but we're not gonna put them in history for sure. We're not gonna do that. Matter of fact, we can even love them. Don't breed with them. Oh, and that's something else. By the way, for you all. I know I get boring at times, but we're going to be talking about shit like the genetic superiority of the American Indian, and the American Indian is the so-called Black African Americans. Excuse me, the so-called Blacks, the so-called African Americans, the so-called American Negro. You get what I'm saying? And during the process of me showing and proving our genetic superiority, I'm also going to be showing you our technological superiority, just period. You know what I'm saying? Just something to give it. But I'm really just going to be showing you, showing, proving all kinds of shit, man. I'm getting tongue tied even trying to say it. You are. I'm just going to go. Let me go. I'm getting tongue. We got different genetics. Let me say this. Let me say fucking this. This is what I'm trying to say. We have different genetics. Do everyone agree? Anyone that's going to be watching this video, can you raise your hand if you believe in DNA? Now, you know, I don't believe in belief. There's only truth and falsehood, but we'll get into that a few times during this series, during this lifetime, during this experience, which is Save Illuminati. And I want you to raise your hand when we're premiering this later. I want you to drop a comment inside the chat. This is me from the future saying, drop a comment inside the chat while we're premiering this. If you know that DNA is real. Now, if you know that DNA, would it be too far-fetched for me to say the differences in genetics can be looked at as different species? And that's why they want us to believe in a thing called race. Now, roaming the streets as a vagabond, they started calling me Professor. You know what I'm saying? Because I was all to the homeless. You know what I'm saying? They had me roaming around looking like, you know what I'm saying? But I was doing that for a reason. You know what I'm saying? Everybody has karma that comes back to you in this life. You can try to change your life. But yeah, something from your old life. That's why they call it a change of life. I'm changing my life. I'm turning my life around. But the whole time when you turn around, you have turned your back on the things you did. So that's why it's better to do good in this life instead of the next one. The whole thing about that, like the whole thing about reincarnation, is that we are living multiple times right now. We're living multiple times, different dimensions, different speeds, different frequencies, different. Y'all, like, no cap. We're interplanetary beings. We're interplanetings, you know. And I'm not joking. I'm not joking. When you hear somebody saying that they got abducted by a UFO, take it serious. When you hear somebody saying that they seen a spaceship or they seen the unidentified flying object, take it serious, because I'm gonna show and prove ancient speculation and ancient, not ancient documents, but ancient reflections or ancient demonstrations of spacecrafts and different things like that. A lot of y'all will be familiar with some of these things, but a lot of these things are straight concepts. You know what I'm saying? Anytime you hear my voice and you hear my face, I mean, you see my face and I'm explaining things, you know what I'm saying? And if I'm not showing you where it's coming from. So anyway, I'm gonna share my screen. I hope I don't be mad. So now let's get back to poor college business, because this is business we're talking. People want to talk business, right? You have a whole movement called the ADOS. You have a whole movement called ADOS that is sprung for. They spawned. Look, the ADOS has spawned out of thin air. Seems to me like that is some government COINTELPRO shit, some agent provocateur shit. Me knowing that my ancestors come right here from this land we stand on, and that from this ancient lineage, that none of them were in bondage, that none of them were in a form of bondage that they couldn't walk straight out the door from, that none of them were ever in chains ever were whipped, ever were brought on a ship, I have the documents and I'm willing to.
It's whatever you are. Like, I'm not really into the debating, you know what I'm saying? Because I don't see nobody that's got it from right here, straight from the source. The source is right here from the mind. I don't see nobody that can go mind for mind with me. Nobody. Off YouTube. But and I'm not braggadocious, because this is really a unique build. You know what I'm saying? I'm not being braggadocious. I'm not being narcissistic or anything. I'm telling you all, hype house. Peace. I love you all. I'm just saying that before I debate somebody, I want to see somebody. I want to be someone who is able to go mind for mind for at least 1 hour or 2 hours. You know what I'm saying? And just mind for mind, concept against concept, reality against reality, truth against truth. If there's only two things, truth and falsehood, then two people can be saying the truth. And then you should be able to expound on your truth. If you have a truth, you should be able to expound on your truth when someone talks to you one-on-one. So when I say someone has a concept, I'm saying that's their truth. That's their speculation. That's their, oh, that's why I didn't know that. Hold on. My bad. You want that to happen? They wrong for that one. So it's been an hour and I'm barely getting into it. Let me, come on. It's just a real good subject. Anyway, we're gonna dig straight in. There, I fixed that. And if y'all don't listen, Indigenous Realist, this is my live streaming channel, and I'm just creating content, so we're going to view this on the other page, but we're going to go down through there and you can just see it live. This is the Black Indian Chief Chicago, and the Indigenous Realist. Hi, that channel is Indigenous Realist, that's the main account. And this is our live stream channel. And I'm finna show and prove in this build, you know what I'm saying, that the planets that they want us to believe are deep in space are actually here on the same plane that we live on. Those planets that they want us to believe in are actually here on this same plane. And also, we're gonna expose the fact, and this guy here, John Jacob Astor, he plays a big part in it, because his book that he wrote called Journey in Other Worlds is a free PDF online. That why the heck? Let me see. I can't because I want to see what category I have my stream under real fast. My bad. But anyway, you can get a lot of information from the main channel, but this channel is going to be live streaming every day. So here, while I try to get this up, I'm pretty sure y'all would rather me just get it out the way right now and check on the stream right now than keep on waiting for it to load and stop. And I'm not going to stop again after this one. Okay, I think I found it.
Okay, I can't figure out how to do it. And we'll fix it later. We'll fix it later. We ain't even tripping. Now, this guy here, he's called America's First Millionaire, and he made his first fortune from the fur trade. And I just showed a little bit about him, how he's been hunting big game. We had a lot of big game over here in America's, big felines, big bisons, woolly mammoth, all different kinds of things, big black bears, brown bears, grizzly bears, moose, longhorn, different types of cattle. We had range of animals over here, the Americas. And if you haven't already, you can check it out on Black Indian channel, the Black Indian Chief channel, or on the main channel, Indigenous Realists. And you can see the two builds we did yesterday, where we discovered the two worlds right there in the Bible in Genesis. And we see the dual creations. And I'm bringing the truth. This video, this series, all of these videos, all of the series, this channel is bringing the truth to Black people, to African American people, to Aboriginal people, Indigenous people, Kemetic people, African people, copper colored individuals, brown individuals, black, brown, yellow, purple, green individuals. This is a message going out to all the worlds, to all the species. Every species, every world, every territory, every creature that hears these vibrations, know that anyone that's conscious and knows that you have invaders inside of your planet, if you still look at it as a planet, or if you look at it as a world, or your plane, or your atmosphere, if you know that you've been invaded and you recognize that we are interplanetary beings, you are me, you know what I'm saying, about it, and you want to know about it, contact me. Our Instagram is contact us, pardon me, pardon us. This isn't I'm just laughing because it's like the awakening, brilliant. The awakening is so beautiful, you all. And for the ones that sleep, they still function off hate, envy, lewdness, greed, competition. Nimrod was the father of competition, you all. And Nimrod, he's the father of competition. He's the father of Christmas. You know what I'm saying? All that. All that information, good information, is over there on the Indigenous Realist channel. But we'll be I'm over here, but right now we're on John Jacob Astor. So, you know, the first millionaires, the copper color individuals, the blacks of this hemisphere. '60s, and back then, you know what I'm saying, we used to use that term to mean knowledge that was purposely, you know what I'm saying, changed or tampered with, you know what I'm saying, to trick people, to trick the mass majority of the world, the 85%, the mass majority, the ones they want to be sheep, the one they want to be robots, the ones they want to be unthinking beings, when we are all avatars. Do y'all get what I mean when I say we're all avatars? I'll come into that in just a little bit when we get on the Elohim and things of that nature. Now, John Jacob Astor was the wealthiest man in America in the early 19th century. And when he died in 1848, his fortune was estimated to be at least 20 million. I appreciate it. If you want to donate, you know how to contact me. You know my number, sis. If not, hit me on Instagram at Sabe Illuminati or Chief Sabe, and hit me up. My Cash App is the money sign IR content. I think that's the Cash App. But anyway, okay, John Jacob Astor, and we're destroying white supremacy through this. That's why I had to manifest this Black Indian Chief, because I love my Black people, you know what I'm saying? And I hate the reaction that I get bringing this culture to Black people, and they're not used to the term, you know what I'm saying, Indian or Aboriginal or Indigenous or Autochthonous or Origine or Original. So they're just used to Black, and so they still need to be taught and nurtured, you know what I'm saying? They still need to learn the information, you know what I'm saying? And I'm diligent, and I will constantly upload and stream on both channels, you know what I'm saying, bringing the information as much as possible. John Jacob Astor was the wealthiest man in America in early 19th century, and when he died in 1848, his fortune was estimated to be 20 million, as an astounding sum for the time. Man, that's crazy. Astor had arrived in America as a poor German immigrant, and his determination and business sense led him to eventually create a monopoly in the fur trade. He diversified into real estate in New York City, and his fortune increased as the city grew. You see what I'm saying? People don't want to invest in my village and my city inside my tribal grounds. You know what I'm saying? And it's going to grow. And then people are going to be coming around and stuff. You know what I'm saying? John Jacob Astor was born on July 17, 1763, in the village of Waldorf in Germany. His father was a butcher, and as a boy, John Jacob would accompany him to jobs butchering cattle. While a teenager, Astor earned enough money at various jobs in Germany to enable him to relocate to London, where an older brother was living. He spent 3 years in England learning the language, picking up any information he could about his ultimate destination, the North American colonies, which were rebelling against Britain. In 1783, after the Treaty of Paris formally ended the Revolutionary War, Astor decided to sail to the young nation of the United States. Astor left England in November 1783, which bought... Okay, this is what's, I think the Declaration of Independence, this is the Declaration of Independence, I think, was 1776. Let's see. And this is history inside of history. When we're looking at history, we can't miss the history that's inside the history. You know what I'm saying? So let me go to that. Declaration. Okay. Declaration of Independence. See, this is what a historian should do. If you call yourself a historian, oh, shoot, the battery going dead, you all. Now, if you call yourself a historian, when you're reading something and you're passing a wide range of dates, you should pause and think, what do I remember from these dates? What can we glean in between that time period? Because we always want to, we all dates. You got to think date periods and decades. So when a date has passed, as like we're reading, John Jacob Astor's biography, you know what I'm saying? That's through. Made me think of the Declaration of Independence, you know what I'm saying? And then that's, you know what I'm saying? Make correlations. You know what I'm saying? Your mind will. Computer-like, which I defined as the analytical mind, you know what I'm saying? The analytical process that you can shape and mold your mind into. And I have tips and tricks on that. I'm gonna be dropping such things as that, you know what I'm saying? To just building the mental power. We got to know that the mind is a muscle just like any other. The brain, pardon self, the brain is a muscle just like any other muscle. It has to be worked, and you work not just the physical part of the brain. You work the nutritional level. You work the energy level. You work the electricity level. You work the intellectual level. You work the mental level. And that leads you into the portal, which is the mind. And on that mental level, you know what I'm saying? You just got to work your mind constantly. Things they say, oh, dog can't learn new tricks. And we're not animals. We're not animals. We're not dogs. That's not our best friend. That's the European man's best friend. Let's keep it 100. That's not our best friend. That's not mankind's best friend. Not on this hemisphere. Not on this hemisphere. We didn't domesticate the dog in this hemisphere. We didn't domesticate dogs in this hemisphere. We ran with wolves. You know what I'm saying? We didn't domesticate dogs. We didn't have house pets. You know what I'm saying? We were migratory people. We had, you know what I'm saying? We moved in like bands of people. When you hear about a migratory band, or you hear about a migrant caravan, we moved in caravans, bands. When you hear about the gypsies, when you hear about any kind of migratory type thing reflected on your own people, because you got to get that sense. When I'm talking about we, I'm just speaking on the people who are like-minded, people who are like genealogy, like, you know what I'm saying? Historical level like me, you know what I'm saying? I consider myself my own truth. And that's the truth that the world recognizes, is that I am American Indian, you know what I'm saying? Hidden through history as an American Negro, hidden through history again as a Black man, which is on all of our birth certificates, if not Negro, if not color, and depending on how old you are. And you know what I'm saying? This is a new channel, so I'm able to relay older concepts and information that's already old on my old channel, 300 and something, and I'm able to relay it with new concepts and new information. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, let's go. Look it up about the history. My bad, you all. I got such an analytical mind. I've been and went off. Now listen, we see. Look, we're right here. 63. He was born in 63. Always working and stuff. I mean, he spent 3 years as a teenager. He spent 3 years down in like 78. Before they got free, rebelling North American colonies. You know what I'm saying? Look at the trickery, though. Not trickery. You just got to pay attention. They're not trying to trick you here. You know what I'm saying? And then look at the date. 1783, which is, you know what I'm saying, the Declaration of Independence. So in between the time he was born and in the time he reached the so-called American colonies, you know what I'm saying, the Declaration of Independence, they came in and they changed the name of this territory to the United States, you know what I'm saying, and 1776. And the reason why I said that was just to show you that we see a reflection of it right here. See a reflection of it, because from the time he was born, look how much history changed. It went from being just the colonies, just North American colonies. You see how they call them North American colonies? Now listen. In 1783, after the Treaty of Paris formally ended the Revolutionary War, Astor decided to sail to the young nation of the United States. Astor left England in November 1783. Remember, I told you September. September is the start of the new year. November will be 2 months later. 1783, having brought musical instruments, 7 flutes, which he intended to sell in America. his ship reached. So you telling me somebody that pulled up, on the shores of the wilderness of North America. Look where he's operating from, New York. That's why I say he reminds me of Donald Trump, because he's operating out of New York. And he literally builds this mass fortune he has. You know what I'm saying? He builds this mass fortune up. You know what I'm saying? But this Negro, Astor left England in November 1783 and having brought musical instruments, this nigga pull up with what? 7 flutes. So we got to look what those flutes are. That them flutes have a different meaning, a different significance, an esoteric meaning, because John Jacob Astor is, his family, whether y'all know it or not, this is one of the most prestigious, this was the ruling family around that time, just because he was the most wealthiest man in the world. You know what I'm saying? And this is crazy. He literally did that. You don't hear Trump, and the importance is you don't hear Trump's family being super important. You know what I'm saying? People, and his wasn't either, but he made his lineage important. That is basically what I'm trying to say. He outdid his lineage. He was the perfect in his generations, if I must say so. Now, having bought instruments, but I'm saying this nigga show up with 7 flutes, which he intended to sell in America. So niggas already knew. Let me see. Let me say this. Way back in 1773, huh? Listen to this, y'all. Listen to this hype, pals. Way back in 1783, after the Treaty of Paris formally ended the Revolutionary War. Remember, we got smoke dropping on Revolutionary War, the Treaty of Paris, and any other thing. Anything you're going to hear us mention in anything, we're going to open all kinds of shit, but not today. This bill has somewhere we're going with this, and it's into some other world shit, literally. Discovery of the new, like that type. Now, listen, after that, Astor left England in November 1783. So look, in 1783, right, niggas already knew. Look, this for the West Coast. You know how we say it on the West Coast. He knew. Saying this nigga pull up with 7 flutes. That's how good he was out here. He knew that if he could flip them 7 flutes, sell them, he was going to buy something else and sell it. This is a birth. This is a fledgling nation, a new creation. There was no business, no industry, just like Donald Trump has did. He seen that everything was going bad. He seen it way in the 80s. That's why I played that last night. He seen that way in the 80s that there was so much trade deals and so much things that were, can you close the door, please, niece? There was so much, I lost my train of thought, but, anyway, he pulled up already thinking he was going to sell something. His ship reached the mouth of the Chesapeake Bay in January 1784. So he get here a whole year later, but they bringing niggas. Let me go into this. Let me say this. Where did he come from? Where? Listen to this real fast. It took him a whole year. Wait, let me see. Let me make sure. Let me guess. It's a damn year. Did it really take him a whole damn year to get over here? Misread it. Okay. Yeah, I misread it. And I'm the type, I ain't scared to go back and I ain't going to freestyle to y'all. You know what I'm saying? That's just about having an analytical mind. It flashed in my mind the months. I can say it ain't take this nigga road no whole year to get to America on a boat. If they claiming they've been bringing hundreds of thousands and millions of Africans over here. And, you know, they did bring a small, minute amount of Africans over here, but the mass atrocity, the mass migration, the mass transatlantic slave trade happened in reverse. They took all the black men and a lot of black women from here in the Americas, the American Indian, this world, this hemisphere. They took us out the West and took us to the East. So when you're getting your genealogy and it says that you have West African inside your inside your DNA test. When you see that, just know that that's your ancestors who are in Africa. You need to try to meet those people. You know what I'm saying? You should try to meet those people, because those are your family that got taken from here and taken over there. And they don't know their history. So you should reach out over the internet or something, teach them their history, teach them about the brilliance of the North Americas. You know what I'm saying? We're from the wilderness of North America, and you can tell the people who got stolen from here, the spirits, the like mind that they have, the certain type of West Africans and a certain type of European blacks, the African blacks, the West African blacks, the blacks in India, the blacks in Australia, all the blacks in the world. This is Black Indian Chief Channel, so I'm just blacking it on out. You know what I'm saying? I'll never use that term on the Indigenous Realist Channel. You know what I'm saying? But over here, we're going to keep it real. The black man and the black woman and the black child and the black people, period. We are, I don't even think I'm screen sharing right. And this, we got to stop dislink ourselves from the rest of the world. Let me say this. This is my damn presentation, my lecture, my presentation. So I'm gonna go at my own pace. I may stop it in the middle of it and resume tomorrow. This is just the beginning. You know what I'm saying? This is just the beginning. Make sure you subscribe to this channel and the main channel, Indigenous Realist. But anyway, you'll catch it on either channel. I'm gonna stream it on that channel later from the future. You know what I'm saying? We'll see it in the presence. So however you look at it, I function in the past, present, and the future, you all. Feel this love and energy and higher power from the future, past, present, wherever you need it from. And we see this video later on that channel. Now, check this out. Okay, anyway, let me see. Oh, yeah, I said we got to keep it real. When someone says they are black, we got to stop acting like we don't know what they mean. We know what the hell a black person is. That is a legal term meant to trick us out of our estate, right? Now, this piece of information I'm finna drop, this smoke I'm finna drop, it should be viewed by indigenous, by like, this information is for everybody. Whenever they, your identity, you know what I'm saying, kind of those terms of black, white, brown, yellow, red, negro, color, African, because that's not the name of that country. Latina, you know what I'm saying? The Latin people think, to all the Mexican people, to all the Hispanics, to all the Puerto Ricans, to the Bodigua, to the Honduras, to the Ecuadorians, to everybody, the Ecuadorians, everybody in the South Americas, Peru, everybody on the islands, to the people of the Australias, to all the different worlds, to all the different planes. Know that you gotta come in or go out. Needs to close the door though, please. The music can't be on my stream. I'm trying to thought again, so let me start back streaming. Damn, bestie. I did a second ago, and now here again, and I was getting to a good damn point. Don't worry about it. We good. Because it's a good damn point. You're listening. But I'm just gonna slow it down. There's no need to rush, you all. Hell, if I get interrupted or something, you know what I'm saying? That means that it's too powerful, you know what I'm saying? Or maybe I said enough on that. I'ma say this. if we don't acknowledge, this is the problem with the Moorish train of thought. This is the problem with the Aboriginal train of thought. This is the problem with the Nuwapian train of thought. This is the problem with the comedic train of, not the comedic train of thought. But this is the Israelite, not with the Hebrew. This is just the problem with the thoughts, the school of thoughts that I named, the Aboriginal community and the Moorish community. And both are two separate lines from the same father, which is Noble Drew Ali. And I'll debate that Noble Drew Ali is the father of the Moors and also this so-called Aboriginal community, period. And that's not a bad thing. You know what I'm saying? He was a master teacher, and he was the first person to bring conscious thought among Black people here on this planet called Earth. See, the Moors don't realize that Noble Drew Ali left the planet. They left the planet. So I heard someone saying that Noble traveled to that. That's a lie. That he did travel to Kemet, he did travel to Egypt. You know what I'm saying? There's proof, there's articles on, you know what I'm saying, non-Moorish articles, you know what I'm saying, newspaper clippings where they named him an Egyptian adept and claimed that he traveled with no one should be, if Noble Drew Ali or anyone else, even myself, we shouldn't be ashamed of our past. And that falls back into the, what I say, reincarnation. When you change your life and you decide life, your past will come to haunt you. When you're doing good in life and you start doing bad, good karma, which is your past, still you were good. You know what I'm saying? That's reincarnation. That's karma. You know what I'm saying? What you do this year, you may regret next year. That's the whole point of the movie, I Know What You Did Last Summer, and different movies with that same concept of someone knowing a secret and then coming to get them for a secret. Start analyzing. Know what you're watching and why you're watching it. Anyway, we're finna get back to the bill. Oh, I want to say this. The problem with those two groups I named, the Children of Drew Ali, which is my master teaching myself, those groups, the problem with them are we fail to acknowledge the terms Black or white, which no matter how much we try to say we're not Black, no matter how much we say this isn't, the European isn't a white man. We know he's a pale-skinned European. We know we are Aboriginals, indigenous people. If you claim you're more, but I'm saying on paper, tongue in with people. Remember, we weren't you owning land and having deeds and things of that nature. You get what I'm saying? Land and stuff was just migrated to, you know what I'm saying? It was just tribal land, territorial land, you know what I'm saying, which everybody defended. You get what I'm saying? So this is all a European concept. So if you're trying to say that you're not Black or you're not white, that's cool. Keep that in your heart. But for the good of the masses who think they are Black and who think they're, who know there is a person who calls himself a white man, who is oppressing him at every turn. And he knows that this white man also calls him Black. So they don't want to hear about an Indian. They don't want to hear about a Moor. They don't want to hear about a Nuwapian. Three groups. Sorry. Y'all got to stop doing it. We got to recognize the fact that categorized as Black on paper. And we got to bring this consciousness to Black people. So that's my goal. So you're going to hear me using that term. You know what I'm saying? Because I am for Black people. I love my Black people. You know what I'm saying? We built this country. This is our land. This is our land. This is our land. We're going to destroy that. Ooh. I hate to have to say it, you all, but we're going to have to eradicate the Arab mind state out of the Americas also, because that's a trap. That's a trap. That's mental warfare. This is our country. This is our country. We have our own prophets. We have our own prophets. We have our own master teachers. We have our own religions. We have our own spiritualism. We have our own rituals. We have our own magic. We have our own deities. We have our own divine higher power. We have our own most high God, singular, the highest power ever, the creator. So if we know that, we can't take a foreign God, because we know that that's their God, their creator, and he got power too. So when you're accepting that dominion, that spiritual dominion over you of a foreign God, you can't separate. I'm telling you right now in 2020, you cannot accept dominion from your heart, your soul, your body. You can't do that. Keep it pure. You know, yourself, and reflect on God, and God reveals itself to you. You know what I'm saying? Himself, herself. God doesn't have a nature. You know what I'm saying? A gender, I mean. Sorry, the nature of God is just everything. He created everything. And I don't even use the term God. I'm saying that's just, I'll build on that too. We are the gods. You know what I'm saying? Those are different terms. And I'm not going to run from anything. If I use a term, you know, for the viewers, I try not to use the term. I'm gonna say it real like it is. This is Black Indian Chief. There are gods walking around. We are gods in flesh. And I'm gonna show you in the Bible. I'm gonna show people in the Quran. I'm gonna show them in the Torah. I'm gonna show them with the Confucius story. I'm gonna show them with the Buddha story. You know what I'm saying? And the facts and the artifacts and the language and the deeds and works of men who were deemed gods all through history, all on all the planets. Remember, different planets. Why gods on the pantheon, the Greek pantheon, the Roman pantheon? Why do you think they called their gods the name of the planets? Because these were different conquerors. This was an assembly of 12. It was the 24 scientists. Y'all didn't know that. That's the 24 scientists. You know what I'm saying? That's the 24 wise men. You know what I'm saying? With the Most High being above all. You know what I'm saying? The Most High created it all. You know what I'm saying? But the 24 scientists that you hear, those are the, you know what I'm saying, those were the indigenous aboriginal men and women who went over there to that other world and conquered and ruled it. That's what I'm saying. What they don't want to tell you is when you hear the Moors, see, Moor is another title that they're choosing to hide our people behind. We got to keep it real. If we're going to acknowledge Black, we're going to acknowledge African American, we're going to acknowledge Indigenous, we're going to acknowledge Aboriginal, we're going to acknowledge Moor, we're going to acknowledge all of these terms are meant to hide the people from this world, this hemisphere, this Western hemisphere that we call the Americas, all of it, Australia, all of it, like all of that. This Western Hemisphere, our world, I'm saying these are separate worlds. If we're going to acknowledge these different terms, we got to acknowledge these terms are just trying to hide us. You know what I'm saying? They use these terms just to try to who we are and hide that. Okay, look, like the Moors. They say the Moors invaded Spain in 711. But in all actuality, Moor is a title that they use to hide a whole nation of people. I'm saying right here, and it's debatable. This is another debatable fact. I'm going to be saying through all this shit. These are my concepts. This is my truth. And I'm willing to debate it with anybody. You know what I'm saying? I'm not a debater. I'm just a master teacher, a master student, a master builder. You know what I'm saying? But I'm saying right here that the Moors are actually the Mayans in an amalgamation of other people. I'm saying the Moors who invaded Spain, that was Mayan invasion. I'm saying that was a Mayan invasion. The Moors, when they conquered Spain, that was a humongous tribe, a humongous armada. It was an armada that left from the it left from South America and went to Africa, swept through the West Coast, the Gold Coast, you know what I'm saying? We bought a lot of warriors and men, women, and like everybody that wanted to go conquer the world. The Europe started looking at it as worlds and not continents. They try to call it continent. It's a different, whole different planet. I'm telling you. Now, I'm not just gonna tell you. I'm gonna show you too. That's why we got all of this. We got the screen shit on, dropping all kind of smoke, all kind of indigenous smoke, all kind of black smoke. We dropping black smoke. You know what I'm saying? The European can't breathe carbon. We breathe carbon. We can walk through carbon. We're carbon beings. We're solar beings. We're diamond beings. We're crystal beings. High frequency beings. We're higher consciousness trapped in a lower vibration, which is an avatar. Which is an avatar. And while you're in your avatar, you're functioning inside the matrix. When you become woke, that higher consciousness wakes you up and you control the avatar. You can channel, you know what I'm saying? Channel other realities. Reality. Now, anyway, I think I'm just building too much. Now, let me get back to the, we finna get back in it, but we finna uncover a lot of truth. We already have. I was saying something I would debate on. I put anything on it. I don't know if they be gambling at them debates over there yonder, but I come through that debate over there yonder and lay some money down on the table, huh? Fight by the two, shoot by the hunt. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, what was I saying I was going to debate? No one is in the chat, you all. You know you can comment. You know what I'm saying? You can do a live stream and all watching a video. But now, and for those of y'all that are seeing this on the Indigenous Realist channel, we're going to be premiering it. So if you catch the future at this point in the past, if you catch the future from this point of the past here in the presence that we lie in the future presenting this truth, hell, I mix my up. If you're catching this thing, make sure you hit the note, make sure you the like button, and make sure you go inside the description box and subscribe to Black Indian Chief. We bring in raw black knowledge. Every part of the every world, we're discovering new worlds in this build over here. Real for real. This is the black hole. This is the black hole. Black Indian black hole. And the main channel of the hive is the rabbit hole. So now let's get back into this nigga John. Fuck John Jacob Astor. We're gonna come back to you all because I don't know if it's premiere later and watch the whole. Let's get shit. Who's heard of Hitler? Who's heard of Hitler and Nazis inside of Antarctica? Who's heard of that? Has anyone ever heard of that? Hitler sent a secret expedition to Antarctica in a hunting fact. They're gonna tell you. Now, remember, as we're reading this, I've never opened up this article before. I get most of the stuff I'm pulling gonna come out of a, you know what I'm saying? And all of the information I present is coming straight out. I know visual people. We want to see more than just a human talking sometimes. People like the information being given with a visual, so they like to see stuff. We're from the show me state of the being, which is the physical, to show me. Why you ask just to show the state. We need to see stuff. You know what I'm saying? We need to see information. I just type random things and not random things I knew what I wanted, what I was going to build on. So I typed like 60 different topics into the Google stand, and then here we go. We're going through them right now. But let me screen share again. Okay. Hitler sent a secret expedition to Antarctica in a hunt for Mars. In preparation for war, Hitler wanted to find substitutes for fat-based products, including margarine, in case imported sources were cut off. So this nigga just gonna survive off butter. Come on, man. Hitler was one of the greatest that this planet, plane over there. Like this interplanetary travel, the catastrophic event that this interplanetary travel and all of that. This isn't just a theory, this reality. Remember, we're functioning on thousands of realities, thousands of frequencies, all at the same time. So I'm just presenting this reality. This is a reality I'm standing in right now. But all three eyes beaming open with. Adolf Hitler used the concepts of Lebensraum, living space. Listen to this. Remember, we're talking about, look, living space. Uh-oh. We're going to build on that. I'm unfamiliar with the term as of now. Maybe someone else in the hive has seen it, but it's not pulling up right now. But it says Lebensraum, which is living space, which is like living room, Lebensraum. You see, it's really Lebensraum. That's crazy, right? Living space to justify the invasion of Poland, Russia, and other Eastern European nations to his people. But one small chapter in Hitler's drive for a new land is often overlooked. How the Third Reich hunger for margarine led to a secret expedition to Antarctica. Let me say this, because like I said, I'm just a model of a chief, just a modern example of a Heyoka empath, a modern example of God body, you know what I'm saying? A modern example of a American black man. Just a modern example, intellectual, spiritual, cosmic example. You know what I'm saying? I'm not special. I am you. You know what I'm saying? I'm not special. But then again, if I'm special, you're special. If you're special, I'm special. If everyone's special, wait a second. The people of the Americas are special. And that's what this whole build is about. I'm going to show and prove that. Look, Adolf Hitler used the concept of, oh, look, when I was saying this, look, living space. This is a build. Check this build. Check this knowledge. Watch this new smoke. Watch this new smoke. Watch this, you all. They're going to see the future, y'all. See it later. Future. I'm telling the future right now. I'm telling the future. If you missed this video right now, look. This is the future. Here right now. And you were supposed to see it. You will see it. You will see this part right here. This is telling the future. You will see this in the future right on Indigenous Realist Channel. But on a serious note, Lebensraum, living. What is this familiar of? They had to explain the invasion. So this is showing that way back then that there was already, wow, what do they call it? UN, United Nations. That's what they call it now, the United Nations, right? So this is the new republic. They've overthrew the empire. They've overthrew. It's buffering. Why do you think Donald Trump just cut the tape on a new war branch of the military, a space branch. If you haven't heard of that space branch of the military, check it out. Yeah, Donald Trump just got approval for billions of dollars for a space branch of the military. It's a new branch. So now your children are finna be learning not just Army, Navy, Marine, but the option for space military is open now too. Did you know that, sis? That Donald Trump started the space branch of the military? So they'll be drafted to deal with the Vietnam War and all the other wars, world wars. Matter of fact, we covered wars. I'm saying children here soon. They're gonna need all kinds of new technicians and new trades and things. And they're steady buffering this because they don't like this type of information going out. They're steady buffering this. You know what I'm saying? When you get to talking interplanetary things, this is why this bill is necessary. Here in 2020, we gotta realize that when Donald Trump just gave approval, when he just initiated a new branch, we don't realize world history got done this already this day. He just made world history this decade, this century. You know what I'm saying? This century, this decade. By doing that, you all, he started a whole new branch of the military. Donald Trump did that, you all. We have a space branch now. So let me get back to the bill. Yeah. Going to what? Antarctica? That's where we are. Okay, we at eight on Antarctica. Oh, explaining the living space. Now, this is the same story of ancient Rome. If you look into, we're going to look into ancient civilizations in this build also. When you look at ancient Rome, you'll see the fact that they outgrew themselves. They overpopulated themselves to death because they'd sit there and bred like rabbits. It was just carnal nature going on. They just were breeding. They didn't care about what tribe the person came from, what lineage they came from. So I'm saying there was a big group of mutts that invaded the Americas, that colonized the Americas. It was a of mixed people. Not a bad thing. I'm just saying that that's a normal concept to them. I need some water. What was I gonna say? So when the Roman Empire, this is new smoke too. This is dry, fresh smoke. This is fresh smoke. When the Roman Empire overpopulated themselves, outgrew themselves, when that happened, they put together a rousing of the Aboriginal, indigenous, copper colored people from the Americas who invaded Spain and conquered that and made that civilization flourish for 800 years, 800 plus years. Those people, they planned a coup. They wanted to overthrow that form of government over there and instill their own. So what they did, they ousted the people hid their history by calling them Moors. So that's why I say Moor is an improper term, because they were just American people. We just went and conquered their world. We invaded their world. And so let me get back to this bill. I had a profound reason why I was saying that. Oh, okay, because overpopulating. So the Roman Empire had broken up. Right, they had broken up. So these are the people These are the people, the old Roman Empire are the people the Mayan Empire went to go kill off and invade and slaughter. I'm saying they actually went over there to wipe out them, get that shit out, because they knew that that was, these are the same people. When I say Roman Empire, this is your so-called Jew, this European Jew. So when I'm saying the Roman Empire, I'm saying the so-called European Jew. In these different European or Aryan type nations, these the people who say or want to believe that they come from an Aryan type people, those people, you know what I'm saying, so-called Caucasoids. Okay, now, and I'm gonna get into eugenics and show you that eugenics is correct. Eugenics is correct. It's correct people for, it's for the Negroid. It's for the Negroid, for the Caucasoid, and it's for the Mongoloid, the American Negro, the American Indian, the American Aboriginal, the American Indigenous, the so-called Black America does not fall into that Negroid category. And I'm going to show and prove that also. You know what I'm saying? Those are specific terms for specific people. And that's why they identified us as the American Negro, because we were similar and had semblance to the other world, to this other world, because we had already colonized that world. You get what I'm saying? The Europeans didn't know. The Europeans don't, that at the time, they didn't know our history. They didn't know that the same world they were invading was the old world that had already invaded them. They thought we were just living in the wild people, unconscious people. They don't know that we were the designers of the law system. I'm not talking to them. When you hear me talking like this, you're never going to hear an American Indian talking like this. But I'm not a Moor. I'm an American Indian. I'm an indigenous man. I'm an aboriginal man. I'm an aboriginal, indigenous, original inhabitant of the Americas and all the islands. I come from those lineages. All the islands, even Australia, our biggest island, our treasure island, our Gullah. Gullah Island. I'm calling out to all worlds. From this channel, we're calling out to all the different worlds. You know how NASA has the little, we're finna expose NASA. We're finna expose all that shit. If you've been in the stream already and you waiting for that type smoke come. Or if you feed this with us from the future, from the past, from the present on the Indigenous Realist channel, when we premiered this video over there on our main channel, just know that we got a lot of smoke coming. But I just want to say, this is a mess. Those beacons. I'm a Heyoka empath. I'm representing a lineage of empaths from the Western Hemisphere. We're not an Eastern people. When you think of Black person, you look at a Black person, you look at an African person. Now, I don't teach African hate. I don't teach Black hate. I don't teach self-hate. I just teach self-knowledge, self-study, self-reflection, self-questioning. Self-knowledge, self-truth, community itself. I form a community itself within myself. You know what I'm saying? So knowing that, I would say when you see a Black person and you see an African person, you know the difference from a Western Indian and an Eastern Indian. That's what I'm saying. Let's stop calling them Africans. How about we call them Eastern Indians? Because that's what we are Western Indians. They are Eastern Indians, the so-called Black people, the so-called Africans, the so-called African Americans, the so-called indigenous original American. They're just Eastern Indians. This is the Western tribes. Those are the Eastern tribes. And I'm gonna show and prove that. And I've already shown and proved that for the people that accept the Bible is true and that are Christians or Jews or whatever. I showed and proved that in Genesis chapter 1, verse 26. You know what I'm saying? The first creation, the pre-Adamite. We're going to touch on that a little bit also, but I just want to just let our people know that we don't have to say We don't have to down the African to accept who we are. And this is a message straight to the Hebrew Israelites, straight to any other group. This is coming just from self. I don't stand for any group of people, any organization or anything. This is a community itself. This is Black Indian Chief just saying that you all have to stop ridiculing and disrespecting your ancestors. We have to stop disrespecting and ridiculing the ancestors. Why? Because we open it up. We got to realize that with white supremacy, our ancestors have already been ridiculed, have already been dug up. They didn't dug up the ancestors in the South Americas. They dug up the ancestors here in the North Americas. They didn't dug up the ancestors in Africa. They didn't dug up the ancestors in Egypt. They dug up the ancestors in Germany. They didn't dug up the ancestors. They didn't just hit the people of Greenland. They didn't just hit the people of Australia. They didn't kill the people of Australia and hit it with a brush fire. See, they're going through a calling the people right now. They're culling the people. The different nations of people are culling. There's a culling going on right now. Different nations are actually killing off their people, you all. That's where you see the virus. In the city I just left, you know what I'm saying? They just said that the first case was found. I knew to get up out of there. It's just a death trap. See, when you're living in a city, remember now, I used the term Eastern Indian, Western Hemisphere Indian, or a Mexican Indian. This is America. This is Amerucan. This is Al-Maroc. This is Al-Marik. This is the America. And that dope got y'all tripping up. Remember, I love saying that. This is America. That dope got y'all tripping. No cap. Now, look. I use the term Indian because or any kind of depiction of an Indian, any kind of depiction of a wild, any kind of depiction of an aboriginal, of an indigenous person, of a person living free, untouched by modern filth, by modern construction, by modern diseases, by modern, they call them Indians, they call them aboriginals, they call them indigenous, and they are Black people. They do define them as Black people. They do hide them behind the term of Black. So Black Indian Chief Channel showing unity among Blacks, but also teaching knowledge of self to the different Blacks. If you are from, we're going to work on genealogy. If your genealogy traces you back to Africa, then we're going to trace it even further. And we're going to get, you get what I'm saying? And you can still represent yourself as a Western world Indian or Eastern world. You get what I'm saying? Forget the separation. Let's acknowledge the truth. We've gone on a world invasion freak. My bad. That's another hour. Marks to me. This is the second mind that. That's just when you hear that sound, just know it's been an hour. I'm a second. We're gonna hit him on camera a couple more times, y'all, because we really can't see the screen, but the frequencies again. Let me see. Okay. Those that missed the reason for this channel, you're like, we ain't leaving, man. We all was Black at one time. You know what I'm saying? Just like all the world was Black at one time, we all were Black at one time. So let's stop acting high and mighty because you found your nationality, because you found your truth, because you found your genealogy. It's just fuckable. Just fuck an African, fuck an African American right now. We're not doing that as historians, as scholars. You know what I'm saying? Let's bring this information to all people. You know what I'm saying? If there's an Asian that doesn't have the information, I've studied. you know what I'm saying, the cultures and the histories and the empires of Asia. I've studied the cultures, the empires of all worlds, you know what I'm saying? And that's how we're able to make this link. But let's, you know what I'm saying, let's get to the bill. Let me screen share. Let me go right to my Adolf Hitler. Send it. Oh, damn. We'll come back to it. I know what I forgot to say, but let me make sure I'm screen share. My bad, y'all. Okay, I am screen sharing. Okay. So he used living space or Lebensraum to justify invasion of Poland. And I was just saying that the conglomeration of the new Roman Empire, this invasion of the colonies that happened in the thereafter mass migration of Europeans over here to this new world, or the old world, as I call it, the Western Hemisphere, that was because there was no more living space over there. They were over there packed, and that's where the disease comes from. Just like the disease came in Greece, just like the disease came in Rome, just like the disease came in Persia, just like the disease came in Egypt, and the inbreeding and things of that nature. And those are all the things they brought over here to the Americas that didn't exist in Americas, because this was the home in land of the free. We weren't overpopulated because the Americas are so humongous. The Americas are so humongous. So check this out. Oh, I just got a mean download. I'm gonna drop that in the bill by itself. Look. The tale begins summer 1936. Hitler had completed a four-year plan to boost the German military and domestic economy to be ready for 1940. He put scoring in March, and then he did a fat plan to enable Germany to improve efficiency of its consumption of buttermilk, cream, lard, cheese, bacon, margarine, salad, oils, detergents, linoleum, and paints. So, you want me to fire this back up? Mm-hmm. What they're not trying to tell you are, what they're not trying to tell you all is this. He really came out here on a trading expedition to South America. And the South Americans, which is the South Gate, lies to lands which is deemed Antarctica, which half of it was under ice and half of it was not, where the pygmies really come from. See, the pygmies think they came from the North Pole, but they really came from the South Pole. Or maybe they did, but we got to realize the poles have been swapped. You know what I'm saying? We think of poles. Pole is really position. But we're going to get back to that. You know what I'm saying? So Hitler, South American trade with the, you know what I'm saying, with the South American Indians, you know what I'm saying? He come out here and trade in that world, you know what I'm saying? And because he's trying to seek information, just like we seen in John Jacob Astor's story, he's seeking information to get to Antarctica in the worlds that lead after that. Now, Let me take y'all through. Like, I like dropping, like, I'm a master storyteller, teaching meanings, and that's what other thing means to be a Heyoka impact. You know what I'm saying? It's an old Indian term for the sacred clown. You know what I'm saying? The opposition to be Loki of, or the sacred joker of, the sacred joker of the tradition over there. That tradition built on all the foreign gods, and we're gonna see that Loka, who manifested himself. myself to go over there and calm all that shit down. And so he anyway, we'll all this shit. But anyway, that's just if y'all ain't familiar with that term Heyoka, just go check that term out. Let me see. Let me see. Hitler had completed a 4-year plan to boost the Germany military. Wait. Linoleum. So look, how you gonna, you think it's more sensible to go get lard from way in Antarctica and pass up South America? So y'all don't think that I'm just making shit up as it goes. I use logic for a lot of my information. You know what I'm saying? Or I applied the billions, no, I ain't gonna freestyle, the millions of hours of self-reflection and, you know what I'm saying, self-thinking and conscious, the different lives, and, you know what I'm saying, beings, manifestations and shit I channel, you know what I'm saying, that type shit. If I just use logic, I apply all that information to logic and see that it would be better to just stop and, you know, get this some set up shop in South America. Why go freezing cold? The little ugly ass, what are those things called? The it look like a seal. I guess they got seal out there and they got those other big old things, the ugly, real ugly ones. Yeah, those. I'm talking from the future. I picture somebody typing in the chat and saying, and I was like, yeah, those. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, anyway, look at the supplies he was getting. Butter, milk, bark, cheese, bacon, margarine. How are you going to get bacon? Efficiency of domestic consumption. Anyway, the idea was to find substitutes for these oil and fat. Oh, okay, he's finding substitutes for these oil and fat products in case imported sources were, oh, okay. If your imported sources are cut off, how the hell is you gonna import your motherfucking, your goods from Antarctica? Hell, if you cut off from everywhere else, how the hell you ain't gonna be cut off from Antarctica? Or maybe is that a key? Is that maybe help us flip the dial, flip the marker, because I'm using a compass. We're going to have to get this mental compass down. That's what Bird Box was about, the little circular, you know what I'm saying, that compass, you know what I'm saying, as long as she had with her, that was a focal point. That was a focal point, you know what I'm saying, the spot in her brain beamed down to that spot on there and reflected back and gave her the information where to go. Something similar to a GPS, just the old version. You know what I'm saying? And y'all think I'm crazy talking about it. GPS over, you see this, what I'm saying? So we're gonna go into that also, in the event. Wait till you see the ancient spaceships. Wait till you hear about to prepare for war. They needed whale oil, says Cornelia, professor of the history of science at Hamburg City and book, The Third Reach in Antarctica. That I think that may be one of the books. Sorry, I don't know. The Germany Antarctica Expedition through 1939 summer haze. They had to buy whale oil before, and they didn't want to sell Norway. They wanted to produce whale oil by, okay, so they're not go way to Antarctica to hunt whale. There's plenty of fish in the sea. The Schwabenland. Look at what they call it, Schwabenland. the ship of the 1938 German Antarctic expedition. Credit Institute of Regional Geography, Leipzig, Richard and building factory whaling ships supply the Southern Ocean. At the time, commercial whaling had been decimated in the North Atlantic and North Pacific. German whaling ships were operating far from home, so the idea of establishing an Antarctic base seemed like a good idea. In August 1936, the German Foreign Office found some unclaimed territory in Antarctica between Norwegian zones, and the expedition to explore and claim the region between 20 degrees east and 10 degrees west part an area known as Hard Land. Lost and Found Mud Tribe took shape. The expedition of 1938, led by Captain Alfred Richard, a decorated World War I naval commander who had married a prominent Jewish artist. He selected his crew for the secretive mission based on polar experience rather than membership. In the 3 months of repairs to turn the Swabenland into an icebreaker, the captain sailed from December 17, 1932, scientists, officers, and enlisted men, as well as two man boats perched on cattle boats. There was one Nazi official on board as required by the regime. He stipulated that everyone listened to radio broadcasts of Hitler's speeches around Christmas time. Ludeck explained. Everyone had to sit in the room and listen. There was one speech. There was some atmospheric disturbances, so they had to switch off. So this is what they want us to believe, the South Pole. Listen, the Indian aliens from the Western world and from the Eastern world. Now they were woke as Indians. This is the Indian Ocean. Let's claim our motherfucking territory. Let's claim our Arctic Ocean, our Pacific Ocean. Think about the movie Pacific Rim. That's what I'm saying. Look at the South Pole. We're going to dig into some maps that show you the South Pole. Look at this tip of South America right here. This is just like an old map. If you notice, they put a perfect picture, matter of fact, because in this series, we're actually looking at how we're looking at the world. Say that, all right, if we want to say that Antarctica, let's lie and say that Antarctica is a place and that it's not just a circular sphere. Okay, let's say, I'm going to just give it up. I didn't want to say it, but we're not hiding anything in 2020. We're going to get that information out. We bucking the system all the way. We don't own, well, I mean, I'm trying to raise it. That's how distracted I get. I really come in. We don't own rights or something. But look at this. All right, look. The degrees are always important also, you all. But we're going to talk. Toucan Sam. No, I'm playing, you all. But Larry Bird, Mary Bird. I wonder we're in the same family as General Bird. Matter of fact, that brings us into the topic of General Bird. And that video, I got that video somewhere up on the main channel, Indigenous Realists. And you can go check it out over there. It's like I went at a computer bowl for a minute. But anyway, this orb right here, this... I'm saying that there's back in the gap within our each different world, our each different planet inside its own circle, inside its own hemisphere. sphere or its own dome. You know what I'm saying? And then that's the micro. I mean, that's the map. If you look at the micro as realms, or them called kingdoms, realms, domains, empires, things of that nature. And territories. So look at the macro of that, or a bigger version of that would be each so-called, what do you call it, but each so-called continent. Now let's go back. What the heck is this? No, we don't want to be on there. We don't get, they don't want us talking about let's go to Hill of Space Plan. If they didn't want us talking about that smoke, let's go to this next smoke we got planned. They really hit with space program smoke. Now look, Hitler parody wiki, we're not going to no shit like that. True story of Nazis invented the space program. Let's check this. This story spawned when I spawned on YouTube, and I ain't spawned on YouTube until maybe November 20. Let's see talking about. It's funny that these stories I'm looking are popping up around times that are crucial towards the manifestation I've been bringing. You know what I'm saying? A lot of the stuff we went over on the old chat, I'm able to screen share, y'all are seeing it, you know, right now, this new finish. Now, the true story of how to into space program by Ezra Glinter. Wow, this is exactly what I'm doing in this video. I'm trying to break the. That's actually one of the subjects of this video. That gravity doesn't exist. Gravity theory. Got that star pulled up for y'all too. We're gonna go to that next. Science is a perfectly objective. The realm, it's an impersonal, it describes the world as it is, to paraphrase the everyone is in, but science works that way. In his 1968 novel, his master, the Polish science figures compare strength the way it is. Scientists may knowledge for its own serve force that be. Although this by ancient space flight present line, that's what I was debunking NASA too in this video. So every when it came to rock military bases, it's hard to imagine a military purpose for sitting in my lap past the solar system voyaging to look. It's hard to imagine a miss for past the as NASA did Voyagers 1 and 2. But if some knowledge for knowledge is happens, let me see what's. I can exit out of the game for this. Nope, I'm trying to go. Right. I'm going this damn. Good play from us. My bad. Intermission. Slight intermission. For when we watch the premiere, just know it's a slight intermission. Let's see. We're gonna be hearing from maybe like to the people that did subscribe to Black Indian Chief. Man, what am I looking for? Needing that that vibrational music. It's buffering. Because they copyrighted me last time in the wrong camera. Okay. I hope that sounds all right, but I can hear it. That's all I need. Yeah. I could have played it just in my head. Yeah. I'll see. True story. Bro, get the view to the Amy Shearer to tell in Breaking the Chains of Gravity, the story of spaceflight before NASA is present between every line. When it came to rocketry and spaceflight, nothing would have happened without military backing. Purely scientific interests were also at play. It's hard to imagine a military purpose for sending probes past the edge of our solar system, as NASA did with Voyagers 1 and 2. But if some knowledge for knowledge's sake did take place, it was on the back of weapons research. The importance of military support has been at the heart of modern rocket science since its beginnings. Tetel, science journalist and author of popular science magazine's Vintage Space Vlog, starts her book with an account of the German hobbyist who in 1927 founded the Verein für Raumschifffahrt, Society for Space Travel. We're gonna look into that German. I actually got a German dictionary. I don't know where it's at. I got a German dictionary, and that's crazy. I got some German smoke. I got some German smoke on deck. So we'll be doing that tomorrow, breaking down some German terms, because we gotta see the German, how the Germans play part. Because a lot of us have German in us. A lot of us have German and merman in us. Yeah, merman and what they call it, mermaid and mermans and shit like that, and Poseidon and shit like that. That's why I'm harnessing my inner Poseidon. I'm harnessing my inner Poseidon. Yeah, I got my green in my beard. This is my inner Poseidon. I'm sailing the seas. I'm all in the seas. We finna uncover some underwater smoke. Not today, but very soon. So make sure you subscribe to Black Indian Chief and get it live, or you can get it as a premiere on Indigenous Thrillers channel. Now, Societies for Space Travel, or VFR, in the back of the Breslau alehouse. Wow, it was founded in the back of an alehouse. So niggas was getting drunk and they founded that. Wow. But even if the first rocket enthusiasts were amateurs who fantasized about taking weekend trips to the moon, the VFR was very quickly co-opted by German military, whose leaders found rockets attractive because sales had not explicitly banned them. Rockets received even more support from the Nazis, although Hitler was initially lukewarm on the idea. SS leader Heinrich Himmler was enthusiastic and tried to poach the rocket program from the army as the war turned against Germany. Hitler also warmed to rockets, seeing them as a potential miracle weapon. By the time infamous V2s were ready to fly, it was too late for Germany. The Allies had landed at Normandy, and the Soviets were advancing on the east. But the Germans were able to do damage to Britain and Belgium. Nonetheless, after the war, the technology behind the V2s formed the basis of American rocket research. And that's what I'm saying. In this series, you're also going to see a lot of German and American collusion and see how the German Nazis, scientists and German Nazi doctors and militaries and martial arts systems and all kinds of things came over here with the defeat of Hitler, or the disappearance, the migration of Hitler. Hitler went and conquered a new world. Hitler went and claimed a new world. That's what I'm saying. Hitler is on a different planet. He's on a different plane. You know what I'm saying? And I'll show and prove that also. But the Germans were able to do damage to Britain and Belgium nonetheless. After the war, the technology behind the V2, it formed the basis of the American rocket research and eventually of its space program. The same was true of the Soviet Union. Although you wouldn't know it from Breaking the Chains of Gravity, Tatel's book purports to be a history of space flight before NASA. Now, what year is this? This is going to lead back to Jacob Astor. So this 1927. See, what I can say is that John Jacob Astor had it before them, talking about traveling to other planets and listed rocket ships. And they're also in the Bible. And they're also listed in the Mayans, the Aztecs. They're listed all over the Americas. And they're listed over there in the East Americas. So let's go and call it a Mexican, the East Americas. You know what I'm saying? A Mexican, the East Americas. So I'm repping for a Mexican, the Eastern Americas, the Eastern Hemisphere, known as Africa and its surrounding places. You know what I'm saying? And I'm repping for the Western Americas, the Americas, the Americas, which is the parts we know, North, South, and Central, which is just all the Americas. You know what I'm saying? The Americas is big. You know what I'm saying? This is different worlds, y'all, different worlds. We experienced planet invasions. That's why it was so much alien talk back in the gap. That's why you heard so much of those type. Listen, the you don't see it in history over it. Man, I'm a build on all that. Don't worry about it. Breaking the Chains of Gravity. Okay. The contemporary Uranian developments are unexplored, leaving the story only half told. It wasn't just German hardware that informed American rocketry, however. It was also the scientists who built it. The most famous was Wernher von Braun, who at age 20 was the first VFR member to be recruited by the German military. Von Braun was largely responsible for the success of the V2 rocket, though there was plenty of credit to go around. In the aftermath of the war, the United States brought over some 350 German scientists and their families, including von Braun's military superior, Walter Dornberger, who made his way to the U.S. after being detained for 2 years by Great Britain as a possible war criminal. The American space program was, to a very large degree, a continuation of what? Nazi rocketry. Just like now today, I mean, now this in this decade, in this presidency, in this turn of the sun calendar, you know what I'm saying? You got the U.S. president instituting a new branch of military, the Star Wars military. What do you call it? The Star Force or the Space Force or some shit. But it's, they're letting you know. When Trump says don't trust the media, and then if he's gonna tell you not to trust the media, and then he's posting so much on Twitter, and he's making so many videos and having so many meetings and conferences and stuff, and these silly black folks ain't going to go see what this man is talking about firsthand. We live in spookism. We got to stop living in spookism. We will not even go see what this guy is talking about. How many times has he came to your city? How many times has he came to your state? You won't even go hear the man out. How many times have you not listened to a Donald Trump video or something like that? This man just started a space military force, and ain't nobody wondering what the hell he going to be defending from space. And they just awarded all this money. They just granted all this money to the space military program, and ain't nobody said shit about it. I ain't read nothing about it on the internet or nothing. Like, that's crazy. Star Wars. Preparation for Star Wars, he said. People better wake up. Like, really, just wake up. Really, wake up. Now, Tito points out, let me get some water. This ain't even like that water. Damn, I don't know why I even opened that water if I wasn't going to drink it all at once. Now, he was a card-carrying member of the Nazi Party of the SS. His rockets not only killed the civilians they were aimed at, but they were also built by concentration camp inmates. With his knowledge and possibly cooperation, although he was also on the receiving end of political pressure. We're talking about Hitler here. I can't see if there's anybody in here right now, but we're talking about Hitler here, Nazi Germany. Although he was on the receiving end of political pressure, he was briefly detained by the Gestapo in 1944 after expressing pessimism regarding Germany's chances of winning the war. His involvement in Nazi atrocities was his own doing, as Tittel writes. When he was first pressured into joining the Nazi Party in 1937, he did have the option of not joining and forsaking the half decade he had spent developing the aggregate series, but it was not an appealing alternative. Suffice it to say, others made far greater sacrifices. Von Braun was also more interested in space or exploration than in weaponry. However, even if he did put his own curiosity above moral consideration, later on in magazine articles and television programs, he helped popularize the idea of spaceflight to an American audience, proposing the construction of an orbiting space station that would serve as the base for a 70-person, 10-ship expedition to Mars. Nor did he have any great loyalty to Germany as the war wound down. He desperately tried to surrender to American troops to put his expertise at their country's disposal. You see what I'm saying? Germany collusion on the space thing, on the travel to Mars. And Mars been popping up a lot too, you know. And I've been wondering, where has been Mars? See, they make the space station. See, we got to realize the space station is a reflector. Look, these different space stations, right? Let me do this bill. Let me drop this space station smoke. Let's get this shit clear. Look. Okay, look, on the space station tip, right? every world has its own space station above it, because that space station is, wow, okay, look, you all wonder why you never see the space station in the sky. There's a space station. Okay, remember earlier, right? Do I have to pull it up? This infinity sign. Do you all know what the infinity sign is? Do you all know what the infinity sign? It goes in like this. Like a figure eight, like the number eight turns on its side. That's the sign for infinity, right? A never ending. Or also the Illuminati use the sign with the phoenix, the double-headed phoenix. Different traditions use it as Ouroboros, which is the snake biting its own tail. Different traditions, different civilizations had different speculations into the great serpent in the great figure eight and things of that nature. You know what I'm saying? But it was actually, all those things actually symbolized the sun. All those things actually symbolized the sun. Sun being, the sun's rotate. See, people think the sun doesn't even rotate. The sun moves on a figure eight track. It moves on a figure eight track. And every now and then it burns out. It burns out of the world because it moves on that figure eight track. Like, and it gets lower and lower and lower. That's swastika from. The swastika is that lowering stage of the sun. You know what I'm saying? That's why they wore that patch. That's what that patch stood for. It was the sun's patch. And you get the sundial from Kemet. You get the sundial here in America. You get the sundial everywhere. You know what I'm saying? And those type things, the compass, the square, and all those type things. But anyway, let's get back to it. Okay, I really want to read a little. Let's get into these pygmies, because now we're not gonna limit, since we're not limiting ourselves, us in this community of self, Black Indian Chief, this community, since we're not gonna limit ourselves to being just Aboriginal Indigenous, we're gonna acknowledge that there is Eastern Indians and there is Western Indians. I'm sending out a call and saying, I'm putting out the vibrations and letting you all know that the Africans and those people over there that we consider African in that territory, those are basically like cousins. They're East Indians. We are the West Indians. Two separate worlds. Two separate but yet joined worlds in a figure eight type pose. That's why they want to tell you that the world looks like a pear, because if you cut a figure eight in half, it looks like a pear, so they could take a picture like that, but they're not trying to do it. So what they do is just take a picture of one side, one circle of that eight, of that infinity sign. And what they do with that is edit out that and make it into a curved shape. And it looks like a ball. It looks like, oh, they're just showing us this part. That's why they won't ever show you two parts, these two different worlds at the same time on a map. And that's where you get in the different maps. And now we're going to move into the map section of this build. Okay. Now, when you think of maps, you don't think of pygmies, right? But you don't think of the pygmy people. Who thinks of the pygmy people when you think of the maps? Who thinks of the pygmies? See, when we bring up the pygmies, those are the dwarves. Those are the dwarves. And then, you know, here there'd be giants. Here in the Americas, in the North America, there'd be giants. And so we're going to go into the giant bone, but we're talking about the dwarves right now, the pygmies. You know what I'm saying? Have you ever noticed the reoccurrence? I don't know if any of y'all read fantasy books, but I do. And I always have. I've read thousands of them. And I've read thousands of nonfiction books, also research type books, informational books, and I've written books. You know what I'm saying? I've written a lot of books. I'm writing an oral book right now as we speak. You know what I'm saying? This will be turned into a podcast and will also be premiered on my other channel. You know what I'm saying? So we're building as we're going. Now, the pygmies. Let me show you what a pygmy look like. So now that we know there's East Indians and there's West Indians, Black Indians, you know what I'm saying? Now that we know, we're going to keep it 100. They call us Black for a reason. Because we this is the black hole right here. You know what I'm saying? I'm coming from the black hole. Now let's go to images. Somebody said, why are there pygmy Indians? See, I can't even say African no more. Now that I know the true and exact name of Africa is a Mexum, which is just East America. This is West America. This is West America. This is the America. This is the central zone. And that is our, like, adjacent piece. That is the reflection. That is the East reflection of the West. The West is the ancient. The East is the second home. You know what I'm saying? It changes over the seasons. You know what I'm saying? It used to be trade back and forth and through there. And then when we invaded, see, we open up a wasp. Let me say this. This is all facts. You can take this shit to the bank. This shit here ain't even safe for me to be saying. That's why I'm doing it over here, because I'm trying to get, see, this Indian support. We don't got good support among the Aboriginal community. So I want that real black power support, because that information I'm bringing is for the black people. It's for people that look like me, you know what I'm saying? Copper colored people, you know what I'm saying? Just because I choose to perceive myself as rich copper, you know what I'm saying, shiny copper, reddish thing, just because I choose to classify myself as that doesn't mean I have to force that on someone else. If they consider themselves black, hey, I know what you're talking about. I consider you copper, you consider me black, cool, let's build, let's stop the division, let's stop the hate, let's stop the separation, let's stop the bullshit. Let's stop the amalgamating with these other cultures to know that y'all are East Indians and we are West Indians. If y'all want to bang after, okay, y'all East Indies. But this is the West Indies. This is West India. I mean, this is the West Indies, the Americas, you know what I'm saying? Pardon me. This is the Indian land. So don't let them try to trick us. That's why they try to trick us and set India was just a marker. That was just a marker, so we know to bring our people that we were on that land too. Because if you look at the shape of India, India is in the same shape of South America. So if I had to pick a spot to leave my presence to let people know, like, hey, I was here, I picked something familiar. And India is in the same shape as South America, and it's called India. And I'm telling you, I'm coming with the truth. Black Indian chief coming with the truth that hemisphere is a separate world from this world over here. You know what I'm saying? Whether we can call them both Earths or not, this is the dual world. That's why you see, I'm going to show you, look, I can show you, I'm just going to can we in the physical. I can only show you in the physical until you open up your third eye and meet me in the spiritual, meet me in the non-physical, you know what I'm saying, in the cosmic, in the astral, in the ethers, you know what I'm saying? So let's go. Let me see. I'm just going to show you this yin and yang. Watch this. I can't cap this up. I didn't make these sentences. I made the concepts. I'm teaching you in a way, in a form. When I say concept, I'm at that created. You know what I'm saying? The sources and stuff I use, they're to the respectful owners. But anything you hear me, my addition to the sources, I'm just using the sources and the pictures to give you something visual. But my vibrations, my tones, my information, my intellect is bouncing off of you. And that's what's sparking mental activity inside of self. And it's a self doing it to self. You know what I'm saying? If you self and I'm self, then it's just one self. You know what I'm saying? People stop the division. bang on Africa. Beware of them in on Africa. Kim Fox. Yeah, I said it back in. Oh yeah, and the statements on this channel, you all, these are the soul mental properties of Black Indian Chief. You know what I'm saying? Don't bring no smoke to the main channel. Bring smoke in, Chief. Now, look. This is, I'm telling you, the yin and yang is our symbol. This is the West, which is the white, which is the pure. That's why they came over here. Soul, which means what? Noble Drew Ali said, I'm not a Moor, I'm not any part of any organization. I am just the fearless chief. I am the fearless chief of the Lost and Found Tribe of Mud, which is just a acronym. Mud is just an acronym. You know what I'm saying? And the Lost, the LFTOM is just to be viewed as a unification point for all people. And that's, I'm even promoting the tribe. Course, and I know people going in a good word, and okay, I'm gonna match that tomorrow this week. Now, listen, this is war, this is the Americas, the black ring. If you actually look, let me zoom it some more. Actually, look, this is the America, this is our counterpart, which is the Exum. This is America. America, the black is now. This black dot symbolizes the ignorance right there in the heart of the Americas. You know what I'm saying? This hemisphere, this Western world. So that means it's showing the mass. But you, if you see this white, this the whole. Stare at it, you'll actually see the black dot in the middle sinking. You actually fall into that tunnel. It's like a black hole if you stare at it. But anyway, you have to do that in your own time. But you can always video and try it. You know what I'm saying? Like, go to your own Google search and try it. It actually turned into a tunnel just like the sun. And that's symbolizing the sun and the moon also, by the way. The sun and the moon, you know what I'm saying? Showing the moon, this is the America. America is by George Washington chopped down. You know what I'm saying? Like, so look. If you look, this part that I told you is called Africa, this isn't even black, because there's a black ring. There's a black ring. If you look at the separation, this is gray. This is black. This is gray. This is black. And the dark black ring going around it, that symbolizes the unknown. So these two bodies, these two worlds, this is a reflection. This is the higher, by the way, this is the higher and the lower. This reflects not only the sun and the moon, it symbolizes the two different culture zones, which would be the Americas on one side, and which would be Africa on the other side. And we see the light because you look at all the Eastern traditions and stuff that came over there. That's why we have Western traditions, which I am a Western occultist, you know what I'm saying, a Western builder, you know what I'm saying. And you got the Eastern traditionists, and I'm an Eastern traditionist also, you know what I'm saying. I can build with anybody, from the Kemet culture, from the Hebrew culture, from the Assyrian culture, from the we can build, like, it don't matter. Anybody want to debate on the whole Aryan Brotherhood thing and the Nazi thing, and I can show and prove that the Aryans were actually just another race from another planet. You know, we're just talking about aliens here. To it. But I hope y'all caught something from that yin and yang build. But if y'all unfamiliar with the yin and yang, I'll probably do a whole separate build for it, y'all. You know what I'm saying? See, when you open up the spectrum, I couldn't open up the spectrums for us like needs to be done. In all actuality, we need to recognize and realize that we are a black man. At the end of the day, they're gonna call. Damn, I ain't been screen sharing this whole time. So I just been doing the whole yin, just talking. Come on. Nobody wasn't in here. And I just did this whole yin. Just gonna put in. And I just play the audio and drop that later. I apologize. This is coming from the future, you all. So by the time you hear this, I have the yin and yang build up on both channels. I apologize.
I hate when that shit happens.
Now, let's go to some talking about pygmies.
Oh, we were talking about the little people. Where did I put the pygmy at? Okay, the pygmies. Oh, okay, let's see what the pygmies look like. Oh, I got my computer back on. Okay, cool.
Okay, now these are the pygmies. These are the pygmy people. Let's go. Well, let me make a book. I'm assuming based off of my search inquiry and based off of the description of pygmies I've read in books, because I've learned to form images out of the descriptions. That's why I tell you all that to be wise women, men, and beings, and celestial beings, and to recognize that, to be able to see if you're part of the Elohim or the Nephilim, like, there's a difference. You gotta realize there's other people those stories are talking about, beings. But anyway, I'm gonna get to that. We're gonna talk about the Elohim and Nephilim. Oh, so yeah, these are pygmies. Look, these fellas are kind of, but hey, we see that they've been bred over here because we got fellas, you know what I'm saying? Those are some feisty guys, you know what I'm saying? To keep it all the way honest. You know, some mean mother truckers, but look at these people. I mean, let's see, look at the features. We ain't gonna give them that. We ain't gonna give them that East Indian card. I'm passing out East Indian cards. We're not gonna give them the East Indian cards yet. Yeah, the Inspector General was saying he bad. Oh yeah. These just East Indians. See, look, this nigga look like he could stay in Inglewood or Watts. He look like a. He really look like he. Yeah, he could stay in Watts. And this nigga, man, this nigga here look like he could be from. Yeah, he could be from New somewhere. No offense, guys. This look like a little young Texas nigga. He got on a hat like me. You know what I'm saying? This nigga is definitely Nigerian or something. You know what I'm saying? But look, she look like she can be, you know what I'm saying, any Aboriginal. You know what I'm saying? So when we doing this, stop doing this African, see you Aboriginals. I'm finna start banging. That's with this Black Indian Chief, because I love you all. I'm doing it for the culture. I'm gonna be banging on these Aboriginals for us. You know what I'm saying? And I'm gonna be speaking out for the Black people. You know what I'm saying? I'm just giving. Apparently, nobody comes harder. No one. There's no African. There's no Pan-African or no Black person or pro-Black person that can bang hard enough to get a point across against the Aboriginal. So I'm tired of seeing the same Pan-Africans and pro-Black dudes get destroyed by these Indians. And I'm an Indian, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna come from the Black perspective, I'm gonna come from the African-American perspective, and the African in the East African prospect, in the you get what I'm saying? Notice I mean the Mexican concept, you know what I'm saying? We're coming from the Mexican in America. Do you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna give y'all some, you know what I'm saying? I'm not sure nobody know work this work, y'all. If y'all ain't buy shit like that, we're gonna have to get all these little homies. Come on, man. Y'all know these are, look, man. It'd be waves if they put a little brush through it. If they brush it a little bit. But anyway, this is the stature. That's an adult right here. This is an adult that is a child. This is the stature, though. This is the stature. You see this guy? Look at this Aryan type stature. That's who was going around. We're going to get into all that. This is what you call a European guy. He looks like he can have some Irish in him, or some Russian in him, or some German, or he could just be some kind of hybrid. See, when you're dealing with species, you got to know that there's no such thing as race. Race in its element means species. And then I'm a scientist, fam. Like, I'm a real scientist. I'm a high scientist. I'm an occultist. I'm an adept. You know what I'm saying? So we got to call it what it is. Go to the next one. Damn, that's the only thing dealing with these people. They want to put the most messed up pictures of different cultures. See, I can't have some of this stuff on the screen, man. I hate to get banned on. Okay, but look at this guy. All right, girl. That's wild. But look at the braids. You know what I'm saying? That's what they're showing you in Avatar, and that's what they're showing you in the movie Atlantis and things like that, the cartoons showing the children back at, you know what I'm saying? They're just showing them. That's all they did was mix the people up, you all. Dang, did nothing but mix the people up. Come on, man. Just look at the facial structures, you know what I'm saying? Just look. These are Americans. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to be honest, y'all. They just have a different culture. You know what I'm saying? Them are Mexican. They from a Mexican. We from America. We from a Mexican. They from America. I mean, we from America. See, it's so interchange. Once you start using a Mexican in America, instead of saying United States and start saying instead of saying United States, start saying I'm from America. Like, I am an American. Start claiming that. And then reflect that on a Mexican. Stop calling them Africans. And know that those are your kinfolks. Those are a Maximites. You know, so a Mexican. Look at this. These people, come on, man. These same people. These aren't Africans. Like, we could say that we're, I'm saying I'm totally claiming up, and I'll debate Africans. That's why we share. I do your DNA check, go off. But if you to a certain tribe, but anyway, look at the stature of this guy. It makes him look tall, but this guy can't be nothing but maybe 6 foot. But look at these little guys. These are grown men, you all. These are grown men right here. These are the pygmies. But look at this weapon here, the fellas. Let's go. Look at the bow and arrows. Look at the bow and arrows. And then you look guys and wonder why they're so feisty over here in America. These one with the smallest stature, because they, you know what I'm saying? They come from. Look, these are grown folks, you all. That's height. They look about 4'3". Man, those are the. They look just like Americans to me. We got an. Oh, shit. We can't. You can't ever just shut it. I always want to do some extra shit. Anyway, you see the United States Declaration of Independence and the Declaration of okay, now we're gonna get back to that. And you notice they call them halls. If you ever read any kind of fiction books, any kind of not fiction but fantasy books, you notice that the dwarves always had halls, and the kings of different lands had halls. And you wonder about that's what we're showing proven. Now, when we're talking about we all about Nazi Germany and Germany's expeditions into space travel, and also their thoughts and their theories and their things of that nature into space travel, and then their journeys into Antarctica. Now let's look at Madame Blavatsky. Now people don't realize who Madame Blavatsky is, and Madame Blavatsky or Helena Blavatsky typed in. Helena Petrovna. Helena Petrovna Blavatsky, Russian. Helena Petrovna Blavatskaya, often known as Madame Blavatsky,
12 August.
They don't know, but of 1831. So look, 1831. And she didn't die till 1891. Wow. Now, was a Russian occultist. Now look, but she claiming her nationality when she's saying this. For all you Moors talking about nationality, nations are worlds, doofuses, nations are planets. Not to disrespect anybody. I'm talking to the ones that it's always saying nationality. So look, Russian occultist, philosopher, and author who co-founded the Theosophical Society in 1875. So this is where this is of this chick, this woman, this deity, this Russian deity, small deity, you know what I'm saying? Because I teach y'all more. I mean, I'll drop more smoke about that. But I go to just Wiki. Just go to Wikipedia. People, yeah, I'm new to it. Clicking on some good stuff for you all. I know I could be showing better stuff, but I just don't know where to search and stuff like that. It said all I do is search inside self. And if you haven't subscribed already, make sure you subscribe into this channel, into the main channel. Okay, cool. Let me get back in here. I ain't seen no chats and I ain't seen nobody in the comment section. I don't know what's going on. But anyway, because I'm streaming from a third party app, so that's probably why I can't see it. Now, born an aristocratic Russian German family in Yekaterinoslav, then in the Russian Empire, now Ukraine, Velasky traveled widely around the empire as a child. Just like you see Nojali traveling wildly as a child, just like you see me traveling wildly as a child. You know what I'm saying? They try to preserve that traveling, you know what I'm saying, inside of certain beings. And I build more on that later. Not all beings can travel within to the planets. Like, I'm an interplanetary being, you know what I'm saying, through your genealogy. Your genealogy is how you're able to travel into different galaxies and different interplanetary travel. I'm telling you, and it's not as sci-fi as you think. Sci-fi is like sci. Look at psi-ops. Sci-fi is to sci, is to be in opposition to your surroundings. Your physical, it's sci-fi, sci in the physical. They're siphon, a scythe, the Grim Reaper. They're trying to kill the physical with sci-fi and have you believing that everything is not real. When a lot of things you think are real. A lot of the places you dream of, the worlds, the different places they tell you are actually them worlds. And that's why I say each world has their own space station above them, because the space station flies above it and it reflects. It reflects the world that's up under it. And that reflection is what they call the planets, what you see with your telescope. And you know what I'm saying? When they say they see something real distant off, those aren't really light years or millions of years. Those are actually leagues. You know what I'm saying? They're talking about leagues and they're talking about distance. And that's why you hear them always talking about building supersonic trains and stuff, because it's going to look like it's just going to certain places, but it's really going to be going further. They're going to open up interplanetary travel, and interplanetary is the different spheres or the different planes. You know what I'm saying? Different spheres. But we'll get on that when we go into this map smoke. Now, the reason, the only importance of Matt Vlasky to this book is the fact this work got a lot of his information and knowledge from, in a lot of his occultic side, and where he started traveling a lot and going to different places, because she was a spy. Madame Vlasky was a spy, just like what is his name? There's many spies. You know what I'm saying? And you got to look at the term of spy. Remember the 12 spies in the Bible. You got to look at the terms of spies. There's many spies, y'all. I had a hell of a download, and I know I can't drop it here. You know what I'm saying? And anyway, we're going to talk about the developing of different chemicals and stuff that went along with Nazi Germany and too, and how doped up Hitler used to be because he knew doping. Never mind, I can't say stuff like that on YouTube. So look, let's see. Now I'm gonna stuff about this. Let's go and keep it. Now y'all always hear about the giants. After the giants died in the Americas, the last of the giants died in the Americas, you all. I'm not saying that this was the only place there was giants. No, the giants traveled freely. And there's still giants around. They're just not here in these two worlds, in these three worlds, in these four worlds, in these worlds that's still around. Peace, K-Mims. I didn't know you were still in here, sis. Peace. But the giants that they're over here in the Americas, you know what I'm saying? It was a stronghold. Stuff and came over here to fight like that. And that finish show and prove that. Watch this. I'm supposed to be clicking on one of these. Giant human skeleton photographs. Ancient names of giants photograph. Let's see. Okay. Okay, well, the number five ancient remains of 5,000 year old giants discovered in China. That's what I'm saying. I just said, they over because we had their foot in their mouth when the first article they giants in China. But I'm telling you that there was much travel around the world, and that this was just where the last of the giants were found or died at. This is where the last stronghold of the giants, and there are still giants around. Archaeologists in China finding buried approximately 5,000 years uncovering during an excavation in East China, with one male individual 1.9 meters feet, 3 inches in height, making them giants. And this is some bullshit. This is why they gotta be careful and just click that bullshit. But they're being some just like. Boom, and y'all, and I'm gonna be having real stuff for the website, y'all. I'm gonna promote the shit on my website. I'm gonna pay up for and everything. There's so much misinformation out here, y'all. And I got it all in my head. It's a lot of it. Fuck. Oh, sorry. I wasn't supposed to. Okay. Free Adamites. All right. I made a bold claim yesterday. You know what I'm saying? I be channeling it today. So then, when I have 10 up, without getting the subscribers up first. Consistent here on this channel, Black Indian Chief, with daily live streams, but you all have to come to them for them to keep going. You know what I'm saying? Even if it's just 2 or 10 people, you know what I'm saying? Just create. Now, reality. Let me see.
Okay, pre-Adam technology, the concept I learned about as a child back in the 80s, 90s, 70s, you know what I'm saying? Pre-Adam or the Adamite world have existed. Antediluvian perhaps theological concepts in the Bible is the proposition that God for the time of, although the Bible says nothing about how this took place, it does seem to indicate that a pre-Adamite did it in a distance past. And that's what I'm saying. We are the pre-Adamites, the people of Western, the people of the Western hemisphere, and the people of the Eastern hemisphere are pre-Adamites. You know what I'm saying? Except those. Now, although the Bible says nothing about this took place, it does seem to end society did exist at the past, and I built on that. I found it in Genesis 1:1. In the beginning God created the heaven and the earth, form and void, and the darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the spirit on the face of the waters. Whenever it is stated that God made the earth, it is referring to restoration, and gives us additional information. Fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, so art thou? Thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into the presence of God. I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be, yet thou shalt be brought down to hell. They that see thee shall narrowly look, consider thee, saying, is this the man that made the earth to tremble, that did shake kingdoms, that made the world and destroyed the cities thereof, that opened not the house of his prisoner? This is a prophecy of America. Thing uses this as a prophecy for anything. I'm using it. Well, 17, the indigenous prophecy. We're gonna break that down as in my Seb Illuminati experience, part 2, where I talk about the creation of Adam and the war between Adam and Iblis, and also check out my Christ Consciousness videos. And those are all on the main channel, Indigenous Realists, by the way. Goes out Isaiah 14:12-17 on that. Indications of people, pre-humans, angels inhabiting earth at the time Lucifer rebelled. Pre-humans, remember, I made a bold claim yesterday that we were, and that there are also the opposition on earth, which are the Nephilim, which did weaken the nations. Give this thought. Jeremiah gives us additional. I beheld the earth, and lo, it was without form and void in the heavens, and they had no light. I beheld, they trembled, the hills moved lightly. I beheld, lo, there was no man, and all the birds of the heavens were fled. Fruitful place was a wilderness, and all the city thereof were broken down at the presence of the Lord and by his fierce anger. America. So immediately after a pre-Adamite destruction, this account of the destruction of the pre-Adamite earth, where its inhabitants dwelt in cities, must have been to destroy most of the sinfulness of its occupants. Over the past several decades, there have been a steadily increasing number of archaeological discoveries, which, because of their mysterious nature, have been classified as out-of-place artifacts. Artifacts we call
objects and artifacts which are found in the wrong place in the wrong time, which may give evidence of a pre-Adamite earth. The reason is that they are in geological appearances in these layers of geological strata, which are very ancient, give non-traditional science evidence of a preceding period of technical sophistication, explorative capability, and people's remains that they were discovered, given speculation. As ancient artifacts arise which baffle orthodox science, we can systematically look for clues or upars, a pattern which indicates the ancient civilizations had highly advanced technology. I'm one of them. The pyramids of Egypt are among the most enduring and perhaps times of advanced ancient technology. The highly advanced in engineering. Other clues in cities discovering off the coast of Japan, Cuba, Indonesia, indicating highly advanced technology. Things I'm claiming. Indian Mahabharata could even give a poetic description of nuclear bombing, you know, nearly 2,000 years ago, handed down by word of mouth from times. In it are described of Vimana in flying machines. Indeed, I've read that all that. It describes wars where terrible waters, the Atlantis scrolls and things of that nature. Gurkha flying in his swift and powerful Vimana hurled against the three cities of the Vrishnis and Adakas, projectile charged with all the power of the universe and incandescent. As brilliant as 10,000 suns rose in all its splendor. It was unknown weapon, the Iron Thunderbolt, a gigantic messenger of to ashes the entire race of Vrishnis and the Dakas. The quartz were so burnt they no longer recognized, but the hair and fingernails fell out. Pop-up cons for the steam washed effect was reported in the Scientific America Journal. A Scientific American, I guess it's a journal, June 1951, volume 7, page 298, was a book. A report was given concerning a metallic vase that had been dynamited out of a solid rock on Meeting Horse Hill. On Meeting Horse Hill. Listen what it's called. That's an Indian name, Meeting Horse Hill. Let me highlight it. So we'll check out Meeting Horse Hill on the later. Meeting Horse Hill in where? Dorchester. I met a more from I met a little brother the more from H Town, but his was Dorch, and he kept on saying, like, bro, I'm a Moor, like, bro, and we were Moors, bro. And our name Dorch, saying that, and look at this Dorchester, Massachusetts. Now on putting together it formed the bell-shaped vessel. Huh? What are you talking about? A vessel. Remember that we're also talking about a bell-shaped vessel, this figure eight, this double world, this dual world that we live in, the Eastern Hemisphere and Western Hemisphere. You know what I'm saying? On putting the two parts together, shaped vessel, but this is something I just make semblances, speak freely when I'm lying. The body considered vessel resembles zinc in color, or a composition metal in which there is a considerable portion. There are six figures of a flower, a bouquet beautifully inlaid with pure silver around the lower part of the vessel, a vine inlaid also with silver. The chase and covering inlaying are exquisitely done by the art of some cunning craftsman. The curious also was blown out of solid pudding stone below the surface. Wow. Another ancient artifact was reported in the scientific journal Nature, London, 1880, confirmation that in 1886, Notre Dame was born, I think, or something. An Austrian foundry found a block of coal dating from the tertiary period to tertiary period. Open there was found inside a small man indicated that composed of a steel nickel alloy. The edges of this perfectly straight and sharp. Its sides were flat, while two remain
remaining opposite sides were convex. A deep groove had been cut all the way around, and been machine made, and was part of a larger mechanism. Wow. In the possession of the Creation Evidences Museum at Glen Rose, Texas, this artifact consists embedded in Ordoth rock with a portion of the hammer still in place. This was discovered in June 1936. At the time of the discovery, Dovician rock encased in the entire metal hammer. Laboratories analyzed the artifact and found that the metal hammer had 0.6% iron and 0.74% sulfur and 2.6% chlorine. I am told no metallurgist today can alloy metal chlorine. Fabrication of this implement required cannot be duplicated. It's crazy. I have Saint Germain on the list in alchemy, and he was from the Americas, you know. You know what I'm saying? And this out. In 19, a man found gold. If you go further, gotta type that in. I ain't typing it in. In 1987, a man found amber on a beach on the Baltic Salt in the region of Kaliningrad. After a spring storm, the man had gone for a walk on the beach to search for pieces of amber. Amber is fossilized resin of trees. Sometimes amber contains insect or and found inside a piece of amber, a tiny piece of woven fabric. The threads of the woven fabric and the amber had a high amber in the Baltic Sea region formed 25 to 55 million years, reported in Michael Cremo's book, Forbidden Archaeologists. That book saying, this is proof of civilization before recorded history. Of civilization, genetic disc. Genetic disc. And we can see the temple in the island that we see with the zodiac. So when he's saying we're talking about the zodiac in the words, that the those different planets that the zodiac grew up in, the different beings, the different higher powers from those different places. Now, y'all see, they call this genetic, the genetic. This disc is a session of Bogota. This shows men and women and sexually, in addition, around the edges is the progression of the disc from South. The archaeologist Upor's place of artifacts. Upor died in any known system of culture. In addition, displays above that which could have exaggeration of the artifact. This black stone and measures about 22 cm diameter and weighs 2 kilograms of a stone called Ludite. Being has been suggested for the stone, but the disc cannot in any known South American the stems are carving with the single vertical stripes. Look what it is. It's the swastika. Sun disk, the squat, the eternity, that type. That's all it is. They just said genetics. A different kind of different word. Keys. It's just, those are just different keys. See that they, you know, find more of these type then, like tokens. Why do you think they use tokens in your arcade or your arcane, your arcade or your arcane? You know? Let's see. Let's see, why the hell is Wong?
Now, symbols on the disc are carved and separated with stripes. One side shows bodies like male spermatozoa, eggazoid, female egg cells to fertilize egg in the male and female. So, ancient on this ancient. Wow, that's amazing. This is called the genetic disc. Wow, this is a genetic disc. The other side of the genetic disc shows scenes of cell division. Researchers are recognized to different phases of human gestation on the disc. Very, so that goes along with the smoke I dropped yesterday, saying that genetic modification has been around for thousands of years, which keep showing it significant are the distant eyes and the broad nose of the zygote, the character of the head. All right, let's proceed. Yeah, I threw a tunnel, then showing it. Wow. Diluvian or pre-diluvian, meaning before the period referred between the creation of the earth and the deluge, which is the biblical Genesis chapters 4-6, records the antediluvian world in a highly condensed account from the genealogical list, the time between Adam and the flood of Noah, which was 1656 years. Many have outlawed antediluvian. Studies have revealed, mathematically speaking, that the population was approximately boom. Damn, I keep forgetting my sign at a boom, boom. But look, 9 billion people are in the world right now today. 9 billion. So we're being ruled by a small group of people, us pre-Adamites. That brings it into a whole different spectrum, don't it? I'm saying there's pre-Adamites. I'm saying Adam is this conqueror, this colonizer, this new person who wants to go everywhere and name everything. They want to go discover everything, the name. They're pointing out who Adam is. They said Adam was, he gave the name and invade shit and colonize the people and give it names and get names, explore everything, give it a name. I mean, put two and two together. And there's 9 billion people here today, and there's 9 billion people back then. Oh man, they can't see Lamb for more detailed explanation. Those and timelines are generated. I'm gonna click on there. Around and said, "Wow!" And that's in the Bible. Actually says in the Bible, and I forgot. Clouds of rain, instead the earth was watered. Yes, wow. Water vapor. Yeah, Hebrew the earth. Temperatures. You didn't know that. So the earth resulting in warm, stable temperatures. Also acted as a radiation filter. Out the harmful effect. And what is this cosmic radiation? They talking about hemispheres. Wow, and we gotta look at wow. So I'm gonna later on we're gonna drop about waterfalls. I just got a download about the geysers and the waterfalls, and that's what keeps recuperating our that's what's recuperating our hemisphere or our cloud source. And so what they're doing is making these fake clouds. These generic clouds. The government makes fake clouds. And I remember I learned it in school when I was little. They made fake clouds. We'll find it. We'll build on that also. You know what I'm saying? Peace, everybody. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, which is Indigenous Realist. Read the bio. I mean, read the description of this video. And come tune in later. I'm beneath the polar ice cap to confirm this thought. Wow. It is not surprising. Cannot find direct evidence to antediluvian civilizations. The Diluvian world was destroyed by the flood. Peter 5-7, there's no new thing that what man calls progress is more of a review. His levels is confirmed by Solomon ration of the Holy Spirit. The thing that have been, it is in know the sun. So what they're saying is the world, that's powerful information. You know how they always say there's nothing new that's been done under the sun. That's because they seen it over there in the east and they come to the west trying to use the same principles on us. But we got a trick for them. They didn't count on the Indians. Counted out the Indians. Now, close out in a little smoke or something like tonight playing. Okay, look, watch this. I can put the picture here, but this is how I see the world. This is my reality of the world, you all. And I've never seen this picture before. Not this specific picture. Who drew this or what? I don't even know if they're gonna let me click it or what. Go back, nephew. The infinite plane. Look at this. Look at this, y'all. This is a perfect picture. Why do you think they call it America's Turtle Island? Uh-oh, free smoke for the three people. Free smoke. This is why they call it playing infinite plane. Do you see? So let's just, you see, this is America. Say this, this would be whatever so-called continent plane go. You get infinite each orb, and what's been happening is the story of Nibiru, and you hear the story of Nibiru and stuff. They're just talking about Africa colliding with America. These two planes colliding and make eight, making a yin and yang, because America and a Mexican, two different planets connected, floating through an infinite plane. There's infinite planes, you all. I'm saying, like, we're all, but maybe on a turtle. This is what they want you to say the galaxy is. Galaxy is. Oh, I hear me them music that good. We put on that. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Okay. The music will start back in just a second. But y'all get what I'm saying? Anything to go on, a concept you can actually, this is I'm a modern philosopher, I'm a modern scientist, a modern occultist, modern, you know what I'm saying, just a modern person, you know what I'm saying. I reach higher consciousness through self-study and self-reflection, you all. And look, I'm telling you, like, just how you just seen those turtle back shaped worlds,
with the ice rings around them. I'm saying this is what it is. This is the reflection. And this black ring, this is the unknown. We didn't know about these other places. They came and invaded. First they hit this side, the dead side. Africa is dead. And then they came over here to the lush. They want to just turn war. We can't let them just black out America. We can't let them just keep defiling the Americas. You know what I'm saying? This is our land. This is our culture. This is our... Now, let's go to the pygmy draw map. I know y'all like, dude, where this nigga getting all this smoke from? Dude got big smoke. Y'all drop big smoke. Every day it's gonna be new smoke. I'm gonna show y'all what this master building shit is about, y'all. And I'm only offering up one-on-one classes via Instagram. I'm doing video classes, Instagram. Look at this. Watch this. Now. Uh-oh, it takes us straight to Mercator's map. I got the Mercator's map up on my channel. You may have to dig. You know, it's 300 and something videos over there on the main channel, so you got to dig. But we got this map over there. But this is actually drawn off the Pygmies' depiction of their land. And look at this. Fighting over the land. You see that peak of land. They're showing you what this is about. I'm big into political cartoons, and I'm big into pictographs, and I'm big into archaeology and things of that nature that show different, you know what I'm saying? Because ruins, I'm into ruins and studying, I've studied every civilization in all these different worlds, and that's how I know they're separate worlds. And I'm gonna show that we're finna go to this plant species. We're gonna show you the different plant species, and we're gonna show you the different, we're going to show you the different plant species, and we're also going to show you the different animal species and show you that these are two different worlds. And then I'm going to backtrack. I mean, I'm not going to backtrack. I'm going to ask you all in your free time to go view the builds, the smoke from yesterday about the dual creation inside the Bible. And you'll see that there was two different sets of animals and two different sets of humans, or the Elohim and then the humans. And this is also how the Americas and how Africa got populated. The whole out of Africa theory is a European concept. You know what I'm saying? Now, these are different land masses, but you see, this goes into my separate world idea, or my second world truth, or my dual world in my different world, my alternate interplanetary travel concept comes in. Look how they shaped it like a little bowl. And you see, look, they have water around it. And these are mountains. Some are spaced out by mountains. Some are spaced out by ice, as you see with America and Russia. You know what I'm saying? As you see with Antarctica and the lands that lie beyond Antarctica and the different things like that. You know what I'm saying? It's all over. Let's see what else they got on the Pygmy maps. Okay, a lot of this stuff, I don't know why they got them on Pygmy maps. Okay, that's cool. We work now. So we know that the Pygmy map is the Mercator map, but I already knew that. Because I already got the Mercator map right here. Look, just to show you, I typed all this shit up this morning. I was supposed to stream way this morning. And what is today's date? Since we're streaming for the future. This is March 3rd at 9:30 p.m. from the future. From the past, from the present. This is crazy. And look, this is another prime example. You see how they section it off? Because they formed the globe out of conquering these different worlds. United Nations, the controllers of these different worlds. And so this is a example. You're showing it that they all got a slice of what? Like an orange. They got to split off like an orange. And
or some other fruit that you make pies out of, orange meringue pie, things of that nature. You know what I'm saying? Look at this shit. They got it perfectly sectioned off. Look at the world of Africa and the world of Europe and the world of Egypt all right there. And then this world right here of Asia and this world right here. You know what I'm saying? Just check it out. Peep it for what it is. Yes, you see, America. They even got it split off. You know, they always talk about California was going to break off. Keep going, though. Let's keep going. Let's see what else. I kind of show you this here. But if you look, you can almost see the different spirits. But you can hold different reflections. It's almost like these. Look, and I'm telling you now in this build that the Americas are bigger than the western side is bigger than they can't have the music. You'll close the door for me.
Still alive, fool?
Yeah.
I see y'all day.
Yeah. Though, huh?
Yo, you live?
Yeah. Yeah. The western side is bigger than the eastern side. They try to say the eastern side is bigger, and that's how they want to draw the map, because they're trying to downplay their possession over here. They're trying to downplay this mass land that they stole right here. You know what I'm saying? Which are the Americas, this whole separate world. I'm saying these two are the figure eight of this yin and yang. This is what you're seeing. This yin and yang, this being Africa, this being the Americas. This is what you're seeing, this yin and yang. Okay, now look. We're gonna go back to the Pygmies. The Pygmies actually say they're from the North Pole. Did people know that? The Africans, the Pygmies, the Meximites. Excuse me, not Africans. We're gonna stop using that term. Africa is really a Mexican. You know what I'm saying? The term is really a Mexican. Now, the mysteries of the first ever map. Gerard Mercator's 16th century attempt at mapping the Arctic includes such guesses as a giant. Now, this is the map. Now, we about this world. The theory, this is me knowing about maps and knowing about history, knowing about in the historian. Know that, right? I'm just looking in its own circle, just like this big one is drawn in their own circle. Look, California. You see, it got California on there. What mountains would these be? Do you see this? This is California region. Then you got Asia right here, and we know that China did used to own California. Wow. Then look, Pygmy. Look at this. Like, these are different worlds. Now look at the color spectrum, right? The color spectrum that look. Damn, it got from color, the different colors. Okay, cool. Okay, look. They might show my location. Now, you see the different things, like Septuagint, Nevum, Terum, Diff. And we're actually gonna, and this is what's so funny, we're actually gonna do a little Latin and stuff. Look, but you see different oils, you know. I'm saying, look, there's a, you know, that look alike. You know what I'm saying? Look for what it is, not what they want us to think it is. Look. Look at this gear. That is a gear. This is a gear. He drew it like a clock. You can see the gears in it. Look at the gear. They'll say, I did the build before on my Mercator map build. And you'll see that when I drop that map smoke, you know what I'm saying? I call it what it is. This is a motherfucking a clock. You know what I'm I'm saying it's built in a clock formation because that's how the sun comes around in a figure eight form. Now, let's go down.
These days, climate scientists are looking hard at Arctic maps. As winter sea ice shrinks and cracks appear, they try to understand the reasons for these changes and determine what we should expect in the future. Centuries ago, though, when people tried to map the Arctic, concerned with what was happening to it, they just wanted to know what the heck was up there. And if they didn't know, they pretty much made it up. Such was the case with the first known map of Arctic, the Septentrionalium Terrarum, which is filled with magnetic stones, strange whirlpools, and other colorful gases. This isn't colorful gases. These are what the explorations of those days, the expeditions of those days came back, and people don't want to accept the findings now. The map's creator, the Flemish cartographer Gerardus Mercator, is best known for the Mercator projection, the now famed method of taking the curved lines of the Earth and transforming them into straight ones. Look, into straight ones that can be used on a flat map. The Mercator projection was invented for sailors who, thanks to its design, could use it to plot a straight line course from their point of the origin to their destination. In the 1569, Mercator came out with the map of the world based on this principle, which stretched from east to west and promised, in his words, no trace of any of those errors which must necessarily be encountered on ordinary charts of shipmasters. In order to make his map useful for navigation, though, Mercator had to sacrifice accuracy in other areas. Specifically, he had to stretch out the top and bottom parts of his map, making the lands and seas in the far north and south appear disproportionately larger than those nearer the equator. See, this is why so many people think Africa is the same size as Greenland when it is really 14 times bigger. The Mercator map is still very common in schools. Nah, Greenland is the same size as Africa, y'all. That's another world also. We're going to get on that. On the Mercator map, and notice I said math, like mathematics. That's what it says. The North Pole would appear so large as to be almost infinite. As to be what? Almost infinite, and we're going on an infinite plane basis when I'm building. So instead of including it in overall projection, Mercator decided to set a small top-down view of the Arctic in the bottom left corner of the world map. Geographical historians considered this to be the first true map of the Arctic. Over the subsequent decades, as new information came to light, the Mercator and his proteges enlarged and updated this original map. The draft above is an attempt from 1606, updated by his successor, Jodocus Handius. But those original bones remain in place. But you see that they're showing it, like I said, in the two-world way. Look at this circular. Look, they're always talking about your curvature, your flat curvature. Here go your flat curvature. Look at this curve. Y'all can see it. Y'all can see it. Two worlds. Look at this figure eight. Two worlds. Yin and yang. Yin and yang. Spirals down. It's going to burn out. It's going to clear the land. Sand. You know what I'm saying? And people know that. That's why you get the forming techniques. You get those forming techniques that do the same thing. Anyway, we dropped the locator smoke. Let's go. Let's go right. We did Adolf Hitler and time race. Now, space race timeline. 1449, Albert II was the first monkey to go into space in an American V2 rocket on 14th of June. 1419 space race timeline. 1957 December 6, 1957 USA Vanguard failure space race timeline. 1958 October 11, 1958 the first spacecraft launched by NASA was Pioneer 1 at Cape Canaveral, Florida. My first achievement of space flight. Let's see if we can get it. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay. We got this right here. All right, first, let me go back because we want to see when. I'm gonna press the back button. Okay, let me see. They orbited a chimp in 1959. Okay, let me go to the timeline of NASA to build out the way real fast. Now, let's see, timeline of NASA.
I had a lot to build on, so let me just go to this real fast. America's indigenous to the North Americas. Animals indigenous to the North Americas.
Okay.
Let's see what animals are extinct. North America is a continent of varied landscapes stretching from east to the far north. Look, they try to call it the Arctic Waste, just like they try to call Antarctica the biggest desert. Y'all didn't know that, right? Antarctica is the biggest desert. You can Google it. Stretching from the, and let me say, all y'all have to do, right, is just go to your search bar and type in indigenous realist, and you'll find out what this Black Indian channel is, Black Indian Chief channel is all about. Or you can just say, okay, Google, and type in indigenous realist. Say, okay, Google, indigenous realist. You know what I'm saying? Or something like that. Now, North America is a continent of varied landscapes stretching from the Arctic waste of the far north to the narrow land bridge of Central America in the south and bounded by the Pacific Ocean to the west and the Atlantic Ocean to the east. Just like its habitats, the wildlife in North America is extremely diverse, ranging from hummingbirds to beavers to brown bears and all kinds of biological magnificence. In between, beaver. American beaver is one of the only two living species of beaver, the other being the Eurasian beaver. Remember, I said it's a reflection, the East and the West. You know what I'm saying? There's going to be double creations because there was a dual creation in the Bible. And I touched on that on the other bills. Now, the American beaver is only, okay, can attain weights of up to 50 or 60 pounds. American beavers are stocky animals with compact trunks and short legs, web feet, and broad flat tails covered with scales. American beavers are kind of dams, aggregations of sticks, leaves, mud, twigs that provide the oversized rodents with deep water habitats in which to hide from predators. Dams also provide winter shelter for other species and create wetlands. So this is where you get the wetlands and beavers with their presence greatly affecting the landscape. And that's why people like wearing baseball caps, by the way. They used to have beaver caps, you know what I'm saying, with the tail as the bill of your cap, just to let you know. Not quite as dangerous as its reputation, but still. The alligator. Oh, I skipped the brown bear. Look, they got powerful terrestrial carnivores. It's one of the largest, most powerful terrestrial. Remember, this is going to be an astroterrestrial build also. The Earth sign has non-retractable claws primarily for digging, and it can run at a considerable clip distance. It's half-ton size, so it's like 1,000 pounds. Some individuals have been known to attain speeds of 35 miles per hour in pursuit of prey. Befitting their name, brown bears possess a coat of black, brown, or tan fur with longer outer hair, often of a different color. They're also equipped with sizable muscles in their shoulders that give them strength. Dig. And by the way, you all, that's why you had the Bernstein Bears.
You know what I'm saying? The Bernstein Bears. Let me show you the Bernstein Bears, right? This is crazy. Mandela effect, right? People talk about the Mandela effect, and the Mandela effect is when Mandela effect is when someone remembers a certain event or a certain thing, a movie, a book, a magazine, a picture, a cartoon, a story, a person in a certain way, but yet history or other people remember it in a different way. And that's called the Mandela effect, because Mandela is like the most famous version or the most famous example of this anomaly. You know what I'm saying? It's anomaly in the matrix. Everybody remembers Mandela dying in the 80s when Mandela is supposedly had died around like in the 2000s. Now, and the reason for that Mandela effect is because there's an Eastern side and there's a Western side. We all have a reflection of ourselves. We all have a reflection of ourselves right here on the other side. You get what I'm saying? Well, gang, or man, this person is your twin or whatever. It's because look, we already dropped some pre-atomite smoke. Let's see, plant smoke. Some American plants, Mark. Is it? Matter of fact, I'm going to close out. I'm going to read y'all a little bit of this into the other worlds. And the reason why this is important, this book by John Jacob Astor, the richest man in the world at that time, it's because being the richest man in the world, he was able to have enough money to find out all the secrets, you know what I'm saying, that he went looking for and that he went searching for. And he was also an interplanetary traveler, you know what I'm saying? Jupiter. Okay, look, chapter one is about Jupiter, the magnificent planet with the dynamic of, see, he's really to these different planets or different worlds or different planes and the people that lie within. And he's, you get what I'm reading? So Jupiter, the man, 1,500 miles, having 119 times the surface and 1,300 times the Earth lay beneath them. They had often seen it in the terrestrial sky, emitting its strong, steady ray, and had thought of that faraway planet. And this is what I'm talking about. The every planet has a satellite, even if it isn't. It's a satellite. When I say satellite, I mean like a moon. Each planet or each sphere or each plane has their own moon, which is a satellite, and it reflects that planet from a distance. So when people see our moon, they see something that looks like a ground sand when they see it from a different world. And that's what we're seeing. And that's why we think there's planets in the sky, but really there's something planets. Those are just marks. They had often seen, okay. Like a strong, steady ray. You see that? About which till recently so little had been known, and a burning desire had possessed them to go to it and explore its mysteries. Now, thanks to Apergy, the force whose existence the ancients suspected, but of which they knew so little, all things were possible. A wrought manipulation.
manipulated the silk-covered glass handles, and the Callisto moved on slowly in comparison to its recent speed. And look, they call their craft the Callisto, and all remained glued to their telescopes as they peered through the rushing clouds. You see, they're going through clouds, now forming and now dissolving before their eyes. What transports of delight, that ecstatic bliss was theirs. The men had discovered of apergy, and now a little lower than angels. You see what I'm saying? They're talking about angels. They could soar through space, leaving even planets and comets behind. Is it not strange, said Dr. Cortland, that though it has been known for over a century that bodies charged with unlike electricities attract one another, and those charged with like of utilizing the counterpart of gravitation. In the 19th century, savants and Indian jugglers performed with their disciples in masses of inert matter by causing them to remain without visible support at some distance from the ground while they... This is what I'm saying. This all falls into the saying that the gypsies were... The ancient gypsies were American travelers, you know what I'm saying? Were travelers between the hemispheres, between the planets, you know what I'm saying? It's in different, you know, I'm performers now in nature. Now, look, I hope we find some four-legged inhabitants. I'm just skipping through. Look, they would not need to drain swamps on account of pressure of population for some time. You see what I'm saying? Any inhabitants we may find, so much land at their disposal that they will not need to drain swamps on account of pressure of population for some time, put in the doctor. You see what I'm saying? I hope we find some four-legged inhabitants. If Jupiter, through its Jurassic or Mesozoic period, there must be amount of some kind of game. Just then a quiver shook Callisto. Glancing to the right, they noticed one of the volcanoes in violent eruption. Smoke filled the air and the clouds, hot stones, and then floods of lava poured from the crater, while even the walls of the hermetically sealed Callisto could not arrest the thunderous crashes made the interior of the car resound. Anyway, I'll probably get on like early in the morning, you all, and just probably read the whole damn book, y'all. I've read it before, you know what I'm saying, but I probably read it just to have it. Let's read it. You're just gonna see it. He's a planet, you know what I'm saying? He's gonna see how familiar these planets sound. And anyway, they're gonna sound familiar to other terrestrial things. That my extraterrestrial. So all that tomorrow. We're gonna get into it. This been good enough, you all. Let's see. Where are we at? Yeah. I've been typing in my stuff. Peace. Okay, peace, you all. I'm about to eat. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna be doing the so when y'all hear this inside the premiere, know that the video is gonna end in about 2 minutes. And make sure you all subscribe to the link inside the description, which will be for this live streaming channel, Black Indian Chief. Subscribe, share the stream, etc., etc. You know what I'm saying? Give mentions to the channel, add our videos to your playlist. Contact us on Instagram at Sabe Illuminati, or type in Chief Sabe or Sabe Illuminati. Both will take you to the same account. Subscribe to both of the channels and Black Indian Chief, and hopefully you found something useful up in this. We said taking longer than import the first, like, so that's a good place to start. I'm trying to look at the thing that was just pertinent to the little section that we mentioned, size, distance of planets. Oh, but we'll cover that when we read more of John Jacob Astor's book. And you know what I'm saying? This is crazy. History can be like right in front of us. We can expose these lies and these myths that NASA put
right here through history. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, y'all, it's much love. It's gonna take forever. It's gonna take forever to download a damn 4-hour video.
Yeah.
Because it's a 4-hour video.